Day four of the six invitational, two eliminations already. We are in survival mode, people. Secret playing for their lives today. I'm JJ, and I'm with Jay and Jay.
The quad J.
Quad J.
Not quad.
I got it on the train.
Yes.
We agreed yesterday that's not how we were doing this thing.
No, we're not doing quad. No, no. We're not doing that. We're not. We're going to go right into group D here, okay? Because we have no shortage of surprises with this group, certainly. And today it is top versus bottom. Like we said, we got M80 versus Secret. Okay. Jacob, you have been riding the hype train for M80, so how are you feeling?
I've been riding the hype train for M80. I mean, look, I got a really bad heart attack yesterday because map one did not go the way that it was supposed to go. I think this team has so much potential that they are finally beginning to realize. It's not just something that we have to keep bottled up in the background being like, oh, hey, how well can they perform? They're finally showing it, but in moments where they're fantastic, they're also showcasing what they're like when they're at their worst. And in this case, their worst is having a massive lead, 6-2 against Heroic on map one just yesterday, and suddenly it got thrown to the Boar Wolves. They didn't close that map when they had ample opportunity to do so. That's really my primary concern about this team, is just not closing an advantage when they finally have it. Because when they needed to be resilient, they did at the very end of that Heroic series when we had a whole tech bug and we were curious how that was going to work out. Are they going to retain the mentality that got them all the way to map three in the first place? They finally do. And now they're still sitting here undefeated through their first two series with a very good chance of still coming out in the top of their group.
Okay, so Jacob really driving this home, but Jesse, they're at the top of their group right now, and it is for a reason. They have had some hard-fought battles.
Absolutely.
I don't want to dump on Secret here, but I mean, how's this going to go?
I mean, obviously, M80 are going to be the favorites. Secret have yet to win a map so far at the Six Invitational. M80 have looked very, very good. Yesterday really tested their mental, right? They had to struggle very, very difficultly against Heroic to get those rounds round after round. It was a very momentum-heavy game, and it's one that, you know, I really am proud of them for winning just due to the fact that they don't necessarily have the coach that they expected to have at the beginning of the year standing behind them to give those TAC timeouts. Currently, they have yet to win a round after taking a tactical timeout through three tacks so far on the side of M80, but still, they look good with the momentum. They seem like they've got that confidence up, so that's really massive to see from them.
Okay, Jacob, I want to focus on M80 a little bit more. So when I looked this morning, Diaz was the top of the leaderboard for overall rating here at SI.
Well, okay, technically he was second on the leaderboard, and then we had some changes come in, and now DS Lucas is at the very top of the leaderboard by ranking. It was him in second, and it was actually Yuzis all the way at the very top, and then in that game against the Sonics, he had probably the most average game so far of this tournament. Came down to fifth. Shaiko's performance yesterday also brought him down from first, which means DS Lucas, where he was last night in third place, is now the top rated player and perhaps the most underrated player of anybody at this tournament. This is an M80 squad that in a lot of cases is underrated because it's not a series of big names. They have made a lot of runs at majors before that people have doubted they've even been able to make playoffs at those events. Diaz has not just been the backbone. Now he's leading in a lot of statistical categories, not just for the team, but in top five to top 10 contention in things like cost and especially survivability. This man is a train wrecker, and I don't know why more people aren't talking about him.
He was our MVP yesterday throughout the entirety of the play day. He's got four clutches overall in the tournament. That is the most of anybody other than Bride, who beats him with just one at five, and it allows M80 to be the most clutch team at the entire tournament. Other than BDS, they got eight so far. BDS have 10. Seems like they're always one up on them in some way. But regardless, it's still been a very strong performance from the clutch when you come take a look at M80. DS is that player who's often been that anchor guy, the one that holds it down, one of the highest survival ratings of any player throughout the entirety of the year. So, you know, it's his play style. It's always what he's been good at, holding things down in the late round. He's done exactly that throughout the Six Invitational so far.
Jacob, I want to zone in on Secret a little bit more. Extremely tough loss last night. And, you know, we've talked about this numerous times in the green room. They kind of have a pattern of being emotional and reactive. I do feel like, and Jesse, you were kind of saying this, they were showing some more coordination and composure. Would you agree, Jacob? Or are you worried about them?
I'm still worried about them, mostly because when you have a guy like Kenju calling the shots, and he is as emotional as we've documented him being over the course of his career, when he has a moment like that where he just sits back in his chair after a loss and you can tell he's definitely feeling it, champion. I think there's a lot of concerns about, are we going to see the old Kendrick come back? The one that when he was losing, he'd be calling his team trash on Twitter, and then there'd be a whole debacle about what would emerge from that. I do want to give him his chops, though. He's gotten considerably better. All I saw from him last night on Twitter was congratulating Canadian on the victory. There were GGs handed back and forth, both after the game was over and online. But it is a mentality driver. When you are, like, everybody on that team is driven by a couple of voices, and if one of them is for some reason down on not having the greatest game, you're not going to have the best results. They do mirror Coy in that way, in a very similar way to how Leon talked about how they typically play. If for some reason he's not feeling it, if his calls are out of whack, if there is some really, really big issue that's present on that team, it does take the rest of the team to kind of bring him back up, and then they start doing better. They are driven by that kind of mentality, and I think for Secret, at this point, you know you're in a hole and you're fighting for your life. So that kind of thing, that kind of really deep, dark presence can't be a factor for this game against M80.
Yeah, also, Jesse, we got to talk about Slubbin. Slubbin put up good numbers in the qualifier. SI really has been a different story.
It has, Jackie, and we don't mean this to rag on him too much, but of course he was one of the biggest reasons why they did so well through the qualifier. You can see his stats there. Second highest rated player throughout the qualifier, number one in survival rating, great on KD, almost a 2.0 flat, but now things have really started to struggle in the actual group stage itself. Now he's on the big stage and things are falling apart. The KPR has almost halved. The survival rating has almost doubled as well in terms of falling to pieces. He's not surviving throughout these rounds nearly as much as he was. So it's been a tough turnaround from Slubbin. He has always been this flexible player for Secret, right? He loves to play a ton of different operators. Throughout the qualifier, he was rocking a lot of little Glaz plays. I thought his Nook plays were really amazing. In their last game against DZ, where they did get their first map win, Nook was banned every single map, right? So I think some of these opportunities that Slubbin had in the qualifier, he's no longer been able to find against the better teams. Some of the ops he's playing maybe aren't going to work out as well against these stronger squads. So they've got to find a solution for him. They got to find somewhere that's going to make him shine. They got to find a way to make him fit in these lineups. And I'm hoping that that can be something they do today.
Yeah, even if he's not the one meant to be getting every single kill every single round, you want a Groovy or an Astro or even somebody like a Savage to be doing that more predominantly than him. I think when you notice that there's a hole and one player needs to be the one filling it, then it's easy to attribute a lot of a team's like lack of successes to just one guy. And we don't want to say everything is meant to be resting on Slevin's shoulders, mostly because we knew that Secret was going to be outclassed by a lot of the teams at this Invitational, and especially in their group when they came in, not riding a lot of hype when they won the Invitational qualifier in the first place, because we knew the environment that they were about to get shoved right into. And we don't have any expectations for a team that was literally ninth place in every single EUL stage last year. So we don't want to say it's all on Slubbin. It is a collective effort, but we definitely need to make sure that Slubbin has a better game today.
Okay, gentlemen, I believe that we have our map ban info ready, so we're working to get that up on your screen right now. To play into the whole issue with Slubbin, though, is this SI jitters or teams just finding ways to shut him down? What do you think?
I don't think it's jitters, because he is a player who's been around the block for a long time. Yeah. We used to cover him back in NA back in the day when he was on the Sonics, and now coming into Secret, he is kind of one of the more veterans of the squad alongside Kendrew. And they're going to try to use that veterancy to win the map ban phase. And Jacob, I got to say, I don't know that they have. I think the clubhouse pick from M80 is not that devastating to Team Secret, right? It's one that they did win in the last chance qualifiers over Outsiders. They lost it here at SI against Heroic, but it was maximum overtime. So they could, in theory, win this in two, especially if Border, of course, goes their way. I'm worried about Theme Park, though.
I am worried about Theme, too. I think Border is going to rely more heavily on the fact that M80 threw that thing yesterday, and maybe there are some things that Secret and Twister noticed in the back that they can exploit. Yeah. You get to map two, and Club, we've seen both Border and Club, it feels like, more than any other map so far in this tournament, maybe aside from a bank more often than not. And then you get to Theme, and there is a pretty big discrepancy overall in terms of who wins it more consistently. That falls on M80's shoulders, given their whole record and the fact that they still technically are undefeated on this thing since they brought it back in Berlin. So if we need to go to three, I don't know how much Secret have left in the tank when we get to that point. They play it way, way more than M80 have over the past 6 months, but that has not led to a win rate of above 50% in the maps that they've played over the past year.
It's a four-game win streak on Theme Park for M80, and that's over Coy in Berlin, Pete Coy, over Auction and TSM in Vegas, and then over FaZe in Montreal. Those are four really good teams that M80 M80 have a win record on. So yeah, it might be tough if it gets that way, but I could see this being a Secret 2-0. And really, given where they're at in the standings, a 2-0 is significantly more important than a 2-1 for them as well.
Still a case of even if Secret were to win their own map pick, you still have a lot of questions, because if we need to go to map 3, I'm still giving it to M80 the whole way.
Yeah.
I was just going to ask your predictions. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious. Do you guys want to drive it home here then? I mean, no hope for Secret? Oh, your faces say it all.
Yeah, I'm looking for the reason to give Secret the edge, and right now I'm just not finding it. So.
Listen, I think Twister is one of the best coaches in the game. I think he's massively underrated. He's done so much to lift this Secret team from a bottom European team to a team that can compete at the Invitational, that can take maps off Dark Zero. It's not out of the realm of possibility, but if it's M80 versus Secret, this is going to be a tough game for Secret. But it's do or die, so just maybe Jackie, they got that SI magic. Not impossible.
One last little wrinkle to throw in on this. So far, we've seen two teams knocked out of the Invitational. Both of them have been APAC teams. Granted, we can argue the strength of regions, but both of them lost 3 games and are already knocked out. Secret have played 2 and have lost 2. If they were to lose this one, it's not a mathematical guarantee that they are knocked out by some miracle because Group D is so close. Maybe they still have a chance. But if they were to lose this game, in spite of whether they win a map in this contest or not, it is very dire straits the rest of the way. So they need this win over M80. M80 don't really need this win over Secret.
Truth.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's get to it. M80 versus Secret, and it's no secret. My Blue and Stokes are amazing, and they're casting this matchup, but take it away. And we got the Stream B pre-show too, so don't go anywhere.
Thank you very much, Jackie. It's time, ladies and gentlemen, to jump into our third out of 4 matches here for the day on the Alpha Stream. M80 up against Team Secret. It is a skewed matchup if there ever was one as far as this group is concerned. M80 sits at the King of the Hill position right now on top of this group. For Secret, at the very bottom, unfortunately, I believe only 1 point heading into this game.
Yeah, not looking too hot.
So some work needing to be done here. Absolute victory is the goal for them. 2-0 is what they're going to be looking for. Will they be able to achieve it? It's going to be a tough ask, at least as far as I'm concerned. There's a bit of a hero problem for me right now on Secret, and the fact that Ruby is just completely outshining the rest of his teammates, and that's creating a bit of a problem to where when he goes down, who's there to step up and take up the rest of the credit throughout that round?
Yeah, well, that's the thing. It's the exact opposite for M80. DS Lucas, the number one rated player in the entirety of the tournament right now, and there he is, a beautiful man, main Lion as his main offensive operator at the current moment, as it's been their favorite go-to info op, and he's been quite dastardly with that gun indeed. So looking forward to seeing what they can get up against Team Secret. But as you said, needing the 2-0 here, well, at least we'll know the results pretty quick here. We'll see how border goes. And I mean, if Team Secret can't muster anything, then that's a pretty easy storyline.
Yep, it will be more than likely sending them to an early potential elimination here at SI. So one more match to go, I believe, for both of these teams tomorrow. Still, they have that bye as well. Not 100% on the schedules for both of these teams. So we'll double check on that as we get deeper into this series. But here we go, folks. You can hear the music in the background. That means it's time to load in as we go to border for map number 1 of this series. Community poll has 75% of you thinking that M80 is taking this one. I'd say those are pretty good odds. 24% of you, I believe it was there, for Team Secret. Let's get into the bans, as something's going on in the chat there, but we'll figure that out when we get some more intel on it. First ban is in, though, and it's a Yana one from the folks over on Team Secret. Definitely not wanting to give M80 that entry boost here. And I'd say it's a pretty good ban with the proficiency we've had for Yana, specifically on this map as well. That's going to be an interesting one from M80, though, as we'll see Capital get banned out as our second attacker.
All right, well, for M80, Yana is their most used offensive operator. They play her 70% of the time, and that's through the 70 rounds they've played at this tournament. So quite a few rounds that Yana's going to be missed out upon. Capital, pretty good when it comes to border overall, just burning out positions. This is one of his stronger maps, just because the tactical crossbow bolts are only countered out by Wamai. So if you don't have that, then he's got the keys to the castle. Solas and Azami, this is going to be no surprise to us. Yep. We've been talking about this all tournament, so we're not going to harp on it too much, folks. These two, very powerful in their current state.
Wild attacker bans, but the defender bans making pretty much perfect sense here. So let's get into the rounds and see how this will all play out. M80's got the attacking side first. They'll be most affected by those attacker-sided bans, of course, as Stokes mentioned. The Yana, pretty much a direct target ban against them due to how much they are using it. So I'm sure Team Secret has an idea of how to get around that when they are forced onto the attacking side over in round 7. Aside from that, they're not looking like it's tripped up the M80 roster all that much. Still seeing a more than capable lineup being brought to the table here try and work their way. The IQ is going to be an interesting one to see, just because for the most part, so far in this tournament, we've been seeing it used as kind of a hard counter to Solas, and obviously we did see Solas just get banned out, so we're going to have to pay closer attention to see how Gomez is going to be utilizing IQ in this setup.
Well, just rolling through Team Secret's operator lineups and stuff they've been doing for this tournament as well, because you and I haven't got to touch on Team Secret.
True.
So I will say this initially, very excited to get to see Kendrick play again. It's been a while. Same for Slebin. Get an NA voice over Slebin names again. It's been like 2 years since he was on the Sonics. It's been a little while.
Yeah, it has been quite a bit, actually, when we think back on it.
We're dating ourselves.
That little stint on the Sonics.
Yeah, we're dating ourselves
2020.
Now. Ridiculous. But actually, Capitao used a decent amount on Team Secret's borders, about 24% of the time, and 60% win rate when they do have that op in their lineup. So, not exactly a bad ban. M80 probably just saw something they didn't really like with those maps that they were watching over, so decided to get rid of him.
Slow approach for M80 at least to start things out here. So they are going to keep at least the IQ behind to watch out, see if anybody's going to be spotted on cams from a distance here, either on that window-facing balcony or potentially somewhere deeper inside of security. They have gone over for an interesting first sight. I believe we're playing over towards potentially Tellers for Team Secret here this time. As they work their way deeper into it, though, we are going to see how the M80 roster tries to take those first bits of map control away from the Team Secret roster. There is certainly some aggression that could be thrown out. You can see this propped up by Savage and a few other members of this team right now.
Savage in a pivotal position here for break. Very common position. A lot of teams really favoring to play around this balcony.
Nice.
Huge nitro cell here from Slebin and some nice shots from Savage. He's down Kino. No respect from NA. Gomez is going to step up and take down Savage as well. So far, so good for them. Kino's actually going to get be saved here. Fortunately enough, I thought he was inside, but no, not going to be the case. So he'd be right outside the horseshoe window here. Still have one inside of Bookshelf. Nice shots from Kendru and Secret. Fire back. Cannon fodder for M80. Remember, Kino also weak from that earlier engagement.
So that's the most convincing start here for M80 as they struggle greatly just to clear out the extension and the security at the moment here. Team Secret constantly tripping up any attempt from any clear things out, and it's all but left down to Diaz now, who's not looking too good for wear here either. Really spamming into that corpse there as he gets the finish off on the
That's a personal foul. Flag on the play for that one, Diaz. It's a 1v4. That was a little overzealous.
Bit of a moot point kill anyway when you consider what is still sitting in front of him throughout the rest of this round. A 1v3 still to be dealt with. Complete lack of intel gain that he has to play with as well. And there we go, the cross from down below inside of Tellers itself finishes things off. We can see this for Secret. They are excited to win that round in that fashion. Put themselves onto the board here at the start of the series.
You know, the fantastic start past that as well. And that's how you want to start a map that you really, really need to win. You need to keep the hopes high and your opponents on their hind legs. M80. Not looking too hot, that first offense there. It's really due just to the respect they were giving over to Secret, which was more or less the lack thereof respect towards Team Secret. They just boldface walked right into security as well as break, and Team Secret was not having it. Some nice shots were landed. M80, not really too much to say about that situation, but fortunately enough, got a lot of time still ahead of them here in border.
Still going to be a first floor hold from Team Secret. In fact, they're working their way over here into Customs, believe it or not, for the second round hold. Not necessarily the site seeing a lot of our teams for our games, at least on border play directly into. So this will be a fun one to see how M80 try to manage this one. Quite a few repicks as a result of that site choice. You're going to see the Hard Breach change up, for instance, over there on Kino as he's forced to go over to the Thermite. The Thatcher even being brought in so they can guarantee the opening at jail. Gomez will try to get a bit sneaky on this round with the Nook. Y'all get staying consistent there on that sledge. They are certainly going to want to open up the top downs to access this site from the inside of security up here, but they'll have to work their way past this extension again. And that brings a callback to the last round where they really struggled just to get that part of the map. In fact, never even really got it.
Well, it feels like they are almost being forced to respect it this time with the mirror in play, right? I mean, you just be lying to yourself if you're like, oh, I can do this. I can do whatever I want in this situation, you know? I don't really see that come to fruition with the mirror windows there, but we'll see what M80 has to say about it. Do the Thatcher in play.
Hey,
it works out for Diaz. I think he's got another one here on the cross section as well. Oh, it's just the mirror window. A little soft breach there to the right. No, they're both flirting back and forth with this angle. So dangerous. Nitro cell out. Kendru just risking it all right now. The Selma charge eats up the mirror barricade. Mewjammer not really able to do much as there's an EMP delivered by Diaz. So very well done from M80. They're making quick work of this site.
A risk there from Diaz, of course, in taking those fights. Obviously, things have worked out, so we don't have any real critique for it. But had he gone down, we could be looking at a very different situation here where M80 may have not actually been able to get open the wall. But props to Diaz here, leading the charge in both the fragging and to some extent the utility front on this round here, making sure that the team is still able to move forward with those entries. Spirits can now take charge on this, try to proceed forward as the secondary hard breach and open up access to customs from the inside of Passport Check.
M80 have their picks, John, so they're going to slow down. They want to use this advantage, use these drones, discover some more angles, some more utility game of Secret. More details they get, better off they are going into this last minute. Apparently didn't see the angle that someone could be potentially working there. They saw him in that position, just didn't know that there was some verticality in play. So see if they can work this out with a frag grenade. It's going to force him off. More than likely hurt the pin through the floor there. So far, so good for M80.
Gomez found out there as well. Quite a few members of M80 being heavily injured here now. Diaz, of course, the damage he took earlier. Now Gomez and Yaga as well, down to approximately half of their HP. Gomez is going to try to go for the east main entry. There is a camera on top of that, though. Already previewing this potential push, so he's gonna spot that coming from a long while away. Astro has the top down angle and will be able to move in, but it's not gonna be a kill from him. It's gonna be Diaz instead that claims Slevin elsewhere. Diaz as well ready for the run up from Astro. The top down fails to dominate as it did in the previous round, and suddenly Grubby is all that remains in the 1v5.
Welcome to the Church of Diaz Lucas, folks. Ooh, Kino puts him down as well. Lots of energy from Divas.
I did the rhythm of Lynn.
Still smiles from Team Secrets. Apparently not too happy with
that. Last kill was a fun one, you know, everybody can enjoy that.
A little confused as to what was happening there, apparently, for one of those engagements. Perplexed, is Team Secrets. As M80, hot to trot, at least in that last round. The initial one, not too much going on, but they immediately bounce back into a positive favor.
1-1 scoreline established now as a result of that Team Secret finally going to the usual default site for this map upstairs in the Lockers Room. A few more kind of fight-heavy operators being brought to the table. Another interesting one in the form of the Vigil. Stokes have been mentioning how we haven't really been seeing a whole lot of Vigil as of late, and that still remains true a few days later in the tournament. Savage as well, going to try to bring this one in as he did emphasize their drone work a heck of a lot more on this previous round. So Savage potentially swapping over to this operator and see if he can potentially work around that and hide amongst it.
Just for funsies here, let me tell you how many times M80 has played against Vigil in the entirety of this tournament. This is the first time. There you go. And they've played how many rounds? 70 offensive rounds. So this will be 73. So it took him 73 rounds to get Vigil.
This is only our second time seeing him in the entire tournament so far.
It's so crazy how quick he's
even that's a lot right now, seeing him twice.
Yeah, it's just so wild.
We're going to continue to see a slow windup from M80. It's obviously the direct play did not really work out on round number one. As Stokes said, a lot more respect being given over to Team Secret's defense now. So they pass the test, so to speak, on round number one here. So that is going to bring a more methodical play style out from M80. Savage trying to play against this with the Vigil's active ability, but at the same time need to be careful not to give over that opening entry to M80 again, trying to postulate a peek towards East Main, but has not been able to work himself towards it. And even worse too, M80 are not really baiting into that much right now. It's mainly that south doorway that they're all trying to focus on. Same for the windows too. If they can establish a counter cross for Savage, he may never even get the chance to try and go for that peek over by the stairwell.
Got some drones in here for M80. Looking for some more info on site. Nades in towards Suicide. Not gonna find too much though, as it seems off the mark. See if we can get it the second time around. In and
nicely
on,
done.
Very well done from Yaw. Got the lineup, Slevin down
in the
for
basket.
The count. Indeed. I think that's an and one right there.
Takes him down, and that will leave us now with M80 in control, at least of the opener. Grubby, once again, this has been the star for Secret. It's been a massive presence, a massive saving grace, you could say, for this team. But at the moment, it's going to be all on Kendru instead, who picks up one exchange against Spirits. Gomez does successfully knock out Grubby on the inside of security. So still a plus one advantage over to our attackers right now. Kendru as well, just crawling his way out of the hot zone here to make it back to the inside of office.
Yeah, Kendru is fighting for his life right now. Able to crawl out, make it through onto the other side of East. Takes down Yaga, finds the equalizer. Team Secret, they're trying to stay in it. They're fighting back, and it's working so well. Kino all alone on an island over inside of Break. 50 seconds left. He's got Case, but no cams. Got some cams around. You can see the rest of the team flickering through them. Andrew down. Savage, such low HP. This AK-12, such a strong weapon in the proper hands. And Kino, he has been so good all of 2022, especially with this team. But, oh, can't feel it out correctly. Remember, Savage is on low HP. Kino has to literally breathe on him. Oh, so very close. They dance back and forth. He knows where he is. He has the ability to plant here. 20 seconds remain. Soma to go down. He's going to use this to cover the audio of the plant. Astro has impacts. 2 seconds remain here. He'll get through it. Impacts out. He knows that he's low HP. Astro seals it. Kino had the opportunity. But the earlier tag, so very close was Kino to clutching this up, but Secret just inches better.
Doesn't expect the dash to come back in through the breach and fountain there. A fatal misstep at the end of it. What an attempt once again. The round nearly given back to M80. Lost, however, after they picked up the opening kill. They themselves not expecting the sudden aggressive swing from Team Secret around the 1.5 minute mark where Kendrew gets it started. A few other members of the team chime in with their own aggression as well there. And suddenly M80 are brought down to a single player who nearly gets the job done anyway, but falters in that final 1v1 with the post plant on the ground as well.
I mean, my heart's beating out of my chest. I don't know how Kino feels, but wow, that was so very close. GG's all around to everybody on that. Top heavy strategy here from Team Secret as everyone ascends the stairs. Vence as well as Cerberus going to be the defensive strategy for Team Secret this time all around. Castle barricades abound as well on the top floor. A fantastic strategy we've seen implemented by quite a few squads, and also that door in particular, one that professional players wanted for a long time in the older version of Border, being able to break up the line of sight down that long hallway. Such a cool feature that they added with that. And you can see just how reinforced Slebin is going to go for this. They don't have Sledge. That's going to be kind of an issue. They have the Ash, though, and they have the potential to have some other breaching charges. So this might be more or less a moot point, and indeed, there are quite a few breaching charges in play.
All right, well, let's see here now how M80 is going to try to use those to harass the heck out of Team Secret's lower floor play, it seems. We'll build up to a pretty interesting late round, I would imagine, considering just how many of these they have brought to the table.
Well, you have the ADSs in play. I was a little worried about the suicide nade coming through again. How many ADSs does he have here, though?
Two.
Okay, fair enough. Fair play. We don't have any nades, but obviously that's a big thing that we would need, so don't even have to really worry about that. So don't have to worry about the burn they would potentially have. Probably just smoke the front of it if they're going to try and do anything over there. But a lot of their manipulation has been over here towards this balcony and trying to get in towards, like, Horseshoe and the break room area.
Complicated setup is spotted over here by lockers as well, so they probably won't be messing around with that too much. It's a little too dangerous, more than likely, for M80 to want to try and set up and clear that out. So they back away from it. Spirits establishes Overwatch. They try to flank from those positions. Like I said before, not going to be too adventurous to claim it itself. Astro in the open for it as well. Potential opportunity presented that member from M80, but not going to end up working out here. One of their members end up rotating back down. It does seem like M80 is trying to primarily push in through jail, an opening they believe have here. And Spirits will eventually strike first here. Once again, knocking down Grubby, certainly helping to diminish his impact. But thankfully, Kendrew and a few of the other members of Secret have been able to step up and make up the difference over the past few rounds.
M80 have done a perfect job of playing things to the absolute limit inside of this round. Their positioning, especially over towards the balcony area, was picture perfect. M80 not stepping up, giving themselves away towards Secret's, you know, positioning. Even with the pulse up, it really seemed like Secret was pretty in the dark as to what was going on, losing Grubby very early here. And now with a minute and 10 seconds remaining, M80 have free reign over what they want to do to this top floor. Still have to find a home for this planter downstairs, but it's looking solid so far.
A little bit of resistance still in the form of the Oryx played out over by Office as well. He's going to continue to cause some problems. It appears another one also hiding still in the mirror on the inside of the small office here, but not too long for this position. Astro will be able to work things out, however, on the Oryx. One teammate dashes away. Another one will rise to the occasion. Two kills in a row now from Astro, sitting at 5-1, matching the energy of Kendrew now with an exact same scoreline as Yaga trades him back out.
Kendrew's under the desk.
Mm-hmm. Kendrew hiding down here. Will they be able to fend off the pressure when the execute comes forward? Kino and the rest of the team ready to potentially hop in through the hatch. 27 seconds remains. They do have a few moments of excess if they want to try and go for the drone game, check things out. But as Stokes mentioned, more than likely, Kendra's position will be unnoticed, and he's got some big play potential because of that.
Has a pulse over inside of detention as well. So much routing that Secret can use to their advantage. Plant going down, but do they know where it is? It's inside on the server stack. This timing going to be so very important. They get the case down. They're going to give Yaga a chance here, and he has the verticality. Has to kill three. So many challenges he has to take, but he gets one. Knows they have to try and fight Metal Stairs. It's so very doable. He's going to be able to get a lot of damage off here. So very low. Look at Yaga's HP bar. He has this. This might be his moment, John.
He knows they
six invitational. Oh my God, what a time. What a time to be alive for Yaga. If there was a time to show your wit, show your prowess in Rainbow Six, it would be now. Yaga, you're gonna make me flip the table if you get this. Oh, Kendrew's on top of it. He has to fake it out. He's off of it. The timer, it's there. Yaga, he's got it! M80!
Let's go! Let's go!
Wow!
Steps away from achieving it in the previous round, and finally they grab it one round later. A massive clutch coming in from Yaga there to shut it down for M80 and give them the round after a brilliant stance put up earlier on by Astro as well. It's all made into a moot point as once again Yaga brings a big clutch into play and succeeds on it this time for M80. They're gonna call for a timeout after that one, interestingly enough.
Yaga, I know you hate when I do this, but that's some cornfed bruiser stuff right there, man. That's a Midwestern boy. Put him down. That was fantastic. Disgusting play. These guys are literally going to give me a heart attack during this game. It's only map one, too. Ridiculous. Let's listen in here and see what's up.
It's an incredibly even individual stat line, too, but we'll listen up here.
Yeah, we want to go on Mario Sunday Shop down.
If they go bathroom.
I can do it. It could be me. I'm usually like a guy on a sandwich.
And we're back into it now. Starting out the game. I was talking about it before we quieted ourselves for a moment to try and listen to the tail end of that pause. Both teams pretty much sitting on the exact same individual score lines right now. There's two players with five kills. I think like one, both teams have one player with three kills, one player with two kills, and one player with one kill, or something similar to that. So incredibly even on the individual perspective of things right now. But M80 is coming on a little bit close with a clutch on that last round. Is able to tie us up once again. Things reflecting very, very close right now. As you can tell, Secret wants to fight for these points. They know that they are at the brink of elimination. That means they need to bring out everything they have. And we are certainly seeing that, but M80 is really not pulling any punches here either, so it's creating a real whirlwind of a series at the moment here. A few repicks coming in. Diaz is actually not really going to end up changing anything. We did see Gomez as well swap over to a buck at the final moment. It's not really finding a use for the IQ inside of this one, specifically since we already have the Blitz to try to force the issue in a few of these areas. But we also are going to get the Amaru pick from Yaga once again. Try and see if he can bring some fun into this one with the Gara hook.
M80 back on their Joker arc. We love to see it. The Blitz in, as well as the Gara hook wielding Amaru. Plenty of ammo in that G8 as well that Yaga will have. Won't have the shotgun this time around. We've been seeing some people favor that this tournament as well. So it's pretty fun. Secret's gonna have the Chonk in as well, which is pretty cool over the smoke. See if they can get it to go on this top floor. It's gonna be M80 Spirits on his shield operator he's most known for. Astro with a lot of damage off onto Kino. Very lucky they didn't remove his head though, so we'll take what he can get. Spirits trying to stay on top of it. Can't get too ahead of himself here, because that's where things go wrong with Blitz. Have to stay kind of like a bulldog on a leash. A little aggressive here from both squads, but it'll work out from M80 on this top floor. Just a little bit of a mess, but they're the ones cleaning up. Really kind of the point of Blitz as well, right? Cause a lot of chaos.
Very much the case. Chaos we did get. That's chaos that currently M80 has some slight control over. Astro trying to put that right foot forward yet again. Diaz found from below by the Tachanka gun of all weapons as well. Slevin able to pierce through those floorboards. A knife for cheese and quickly knock out one of the members of the team. Spirit So getting the flash out. He gets revenge against Astro, but Kendro once again able to trade it back into his team's favor. Secret refuses to give up on these gunfights, so we are even yet again down to a 2v2. And unfortunately for M80, one of those remaining players is the Blitz.
Low HP for both of them, though, and Kendro is still alive, which is the bane of any shield player's existence. Oryx So he can simply just knock spirits on his butt. He got a big problem past that. Slubman's going to have full HP as well still, and a lot of those fire nades to prevent anything going on objective-wise. I mean, he's real chance. Try and get a pick here. See if he can influence this. Get some info game or something along those lines. We still have a drone here on spirits, but it's more than likely on a flank watch, so might not adjust that. Could be worrisome. We get the angle here, Slubman. Lots of damage, but Slubman, oh!
Issue with that gun.
Not what you wanted to see. Kino's going to drop some stuns in. Kendru. Oh, so unfortunate. Completely blind. Like he's staring into the sun, and an M80 rather guns him down.
Misjudged the Candela drop position. Thought he would have been able to creep forward without being affected by it. A fatal mistake that ends up costing Team Secret the round. However, only one behind here, so fairly easy still for the team to bounce back into it. With the seesaw-y nature that we've had in this game so far, I'd say it's almost a likely outcome of at least one of these upcoming rounds. Only one more remaining for the half, though, so it's Team Secret's last chance to make an impact here and keep us at an even keel before we reach halftime and decide if M80 is going to hold that advantage or not. Glass selection in for M80. We'll see if they stick with this. Once again, the resounding answer is no, as they go back to the IQ, it looks like, on the rethink.
It's always a bait, it seems, for the majority of teams.
I'm telling you. It's just, I don't think it works.
There's going to be one game where...
I don't think it works.
I'm so proud of you, John. You have an opinion on this broadcast. You do it.
Glass is bad.
He is bad. Say it. Say it with your chest.
Keep him off your roster. What are you doing?
Exactly. Thank you. Thank you, John.
See,
I appreciate
smoke,
that.
Soak and Warden. So
good stuff.
Not even special.
Boom. He's not even special.
Not even unique anymore.
Bulletproofs can see through stuff. Warden can see. There's so many people that are glass
That's
better.
A horrible point to make there.
I mean, but like to be fair, all of the defensive utility actually just plays back at him. So it's like.
And it's like it's so obvious when you play him usually. Like
this. I wonder what this
second
smoke
he shoots
is for.
Anything. It's like, well, oh, I wonder what he's gonna do. Like
my favorite is when they set the smoke right on the edge of the site. Like no one's gonna understand why that smoke is just randomly there this time around. Oh, I'm hiding it.
Also,
ooh.
Like, it's like, when else do you do a smoke execute? Current meta. Like,
yes.
Like, there's a few other strats on certain maps, but that's really it. Like,
Now, here's the thing. I don't knock him for trying because there is, I am sure, every once in a while where that strat works so beautiful in scrims. But just not today, or really ever on broadcast, which really sucks because back in the day, Ying Glass meta used to be so crazy to watch. Entire defense would just die instantaneously. And if they didn't, they just die inside, really.
So the action getting started here. We'll pay close attention because things have been heating up very quickly on these rounds, and this one going to be no exception. Team Secret immediately pinching out the east push here. Slept getting the confirmation on Kino. Keep in mind, Spirits is still down as well, yet to be confirmed over on the south balcony. There we go. The confirmation now in. Already a two-kill advantage over to Secret for this round here. They're looking to make a statement on the final round.
Wow.
Half and Slevin with the drive-by. Certainly trying to seal the deal here as he knocks out Gomez.
Well, y'all got a heck of a round the last time, but yeah, went back to the casino. All he found was lead. It's gonna be Diaz. Lights up Kendrick, but now they know exactly where he is. He's gonna get the business real quick from Groovy. It's gonna be a flawless round from Secret. They bring it back to even keel here on Border.
All right, so 3-3 scoreline. Both teams neck and neck at a near back and forth affair throughout the entirety of the half there. I think the teams each managed to get a double round peat at one point during it, but aside from that, very much a repeat for both teams. Moving into the second half now, it's M80's turn on the defensive side. We'll see how active they can be and if they're going to try to get in the face of Team Secret as often as we were seeing them try to do so against M80, or if M80 will strain themselves a little bit more. Allow Secret to go for their opening executes and play things out in a normal fashion. Speaking of a normal fashion, Secret with very few surprises when it comes to their operator lineup. Things are going to be pretty basic as far as their picks are concerned. It's a little bit more complex, and we do see the repick come out from Gerby, of course, going to add a little bit more direct flight counter into it. And Astro will now just switch over to the sledge as they still need that top-down opener to be brought back. Okay, maybe they don't. Doubling back onto it there. He ends up on the Ash, feeling that the charges from Ash's grenade launcher are going to be good enough to do the top-down work they need.
Maybe it's just something about the G36C.
They're really switching it around here, too, because now Savage has the sledge back. Kendrew's gone over to the Twitch. This took a lot of repicking to get the final lineup.
That's one of those, you just look across the desk and go, I'm better than you on Twitch.
Yeah, I think they were like,
they're
debating who should get the Twitch right there.
Savage is probably like, oh, yeah, I'll play the F2. And they're like, the grip's off. And he's like, oh, yeah, I don't want to play Twitch. He's like, give me sledge, Kendrew, please. Kendry's like, fine.
Kendry's like, check the KDs.
He's like, fine, I'll do it with the 417. Watch this.
I'm the captain now.
Oh, no way. No way, no how, DS. I thought he saw it. Thought he laid eyes on the Twitch drone.
Apparently not. Just bye-bye to the probably most important mirror window we have down on this round. Just a straight hole opening up into that balcony entrance over into the site. Now, not the best way for M80 to start this one out. They do have to just kind of give up that part of the map by default or play very carefully around the window at a minimum here. A lot of stack players from M80 over here by east side as well. So we'll have to see what they're potentially trying to cook up. Quite a bit of a stack deployed, but it does go back into normal positions. It looks like maybe just trying to posture up for something crazy if we saw a bigger east push from Team Secret, but they never really obliged it, so M80 also de-stacks their positioning.
Well, not too much of a frontal assault into the building just yet. Nice gunfight there. Spirits will end up losing that. Astro's on very low HP now, though. Savage will go down. Some nice trade outs from M80 as they will regather the lead. Astro's still very low on HP as he was not one of the targets of that assault. M80 looking quite solid here, but Slebin finding an angle. So many M80 bodies piled high there. Practically couldn't miss firing in a volley. Able to take down one. DS, though, he's going to fire back. It is constantly Secret, just trying to find these off angles up against the M80 setup. Trying to work things around break side as well as the office area. Slebin's going to get off of east, it seems. Kendrick has the case, so it seems like Slebin's going to have to try and rotate over to him, but everything down here is barricaded. Everything is an audio cue. The cam might even still be up for default. I mean, who knows how far Team Secret even got down here? They didn't see too much. Oh, they got a drone down here. They know where one is. Oh, good night, Gomez. Slebin opening up the gate here. They might actually have this 2v2.
Kendrew, need me to try and pierce into the site, though. That's going to be the key part of this. How do they get access to a plan angle? 30 seconds to go, so very decent amount of time in order to make this work. Kendrew with the wrong guess initially. He tries to push forward deeper into archives, but there's reason behind that as M80 is giving up those positions. Kendrew, though, clipped off, and the same can be said for the last remaining player as well. M80 suddenly jumps out of nowhere, finds the winning angle for those final two kills. Puts up a stalwart defense instead, winning things out in round number seven, locking in that lead for the foreseeable future.
Back and forth we go, it seems. Team Secrets unable to get things going on that offensive side instead of the 2v2. Really good job of working the map, though, keeping things active. Also, shout out to everybody that was dead there as well for staying active on cams. As much as that seems like a fundamental of Siege, you know, it even escapes professional players sometimes. So just good on them for staying heads up, making sure that they are assisting the roster at all times, staying active. Almost had it there at the dying moments, but M80 able to muster up just at the tad bit there, resurge into the defensive part. Able to pick up those last two kills. So M80 are going to send it down to the bathroom now. Kino going to be on dock. We see M80 work dock in every once in a while. I think we've seen it a couple of times here on their borders previously as well. Just for some of those longer angles. Plus, I mean, border tends to be a pretty, you know, fight heavy map, even though, you know, that's kind of the point of Siege past that, right? But it makes it to where you can take a lot more of those fights, especially with dock nowadays. He heals you for so much HP. I think it's 200 flat now, which is just absolutely crazy.
So we'll see the doc brought in for Keno. See what he can work with this operator. Quite a versatile one when it comes to just his capability to solo play. I mentioned the gun work that can be made with him as well, but no immediate success being seen in these first few seconds here, which is where we normally tend to see the doc shenanigans play out. Very well-positioned drone going to be a constant info drip here now. This is one that is more than likely not going to get spotted by the defenders unless they have a very keen eye behind that bag up there. So Grubby has a lot to work with. The problem is he's the only one on the drone at the moment, so it's not necessarily the most reliable intel. It's going to be a hope that he has a teammate to watch this one for him when he's ready to make that leap forward. Keep in mind, he can no longer see that dock position deeper on the inside, and it does appear that Kino suspects something. Nate goes right on top of Gomez there. Almost a big misstep. So obviously that would have been done by a member of Team Secret. You know, that gets caught out by Diaz. That actually takes some hits. Potentially from that spray there. He's brought down to half HP, but it's going to be Kino spotted out first by Savage, and that should potentially open up the wayside for the Amaru swing now. Spirit's able to find a trade, being able to keep control of the immediate area near office as well as Fountain. But Groovy officially in now, taking that control away and starting the pinch to force those players away.
Very unfortunate that Kino happened to be the first one to go down there, as TS could definitely use one of those stems at the current moment, but I mean, it's a fair shake there for M80 as Savage is down, so therefore lacking Lion, but Groovy making it hard now with the G8 as he takes out two Insight, standing on the server stack, tall, as we're working this one out quite well. Yeah, still holding things down at the back end. Not too much happening past that. Just trying to stay stalwart.
Nice.
And just tries to attempt to let M80 work out his positioning. They give up the goods yet again here, and he's good for three in that round. Secret, so decisive there, especially for Groovy.
Buckle up, ladies and gentlemen, as it does look like this is going to be a long one here. Both teams proving their worth pretty much instantly inside of both halves here, with the response round being won both times. 1-1 on the first two rounds of both halves here so far, and that's going to keep us even now at 4-4 between these teams. Ventilation Hold coming up next for M80 as they try to rebound yet again and hold on to this lead so they can at least try to work their way up to 6 before their opponents do and have potentially that one more round opportunity to win this one in regulation.
No Jaeger here for M80, but more likely won't need it. Gonna bring the castle barricades back. Definitely see this being a little more dedicated towards the top floor, but that's not what M80 is thinking. They're thinking about castle barricading up jungle as well as Vent's window here. Astro does have Sledge, so a couple of these will be pretty fairly, you know, straightforward for them. He's gonna switch it on over to the Ash, so might be a little bit worried about something else here. These castle barricades might play a hand into things later on. They can definitely mess up some rotations and past that, especially depending on the picks that M80 can get. There's some times where it's practically impossible to use those as an avenue to work your way around the map. Otherwise, have to try and circumnavigate them, use other spaces, and your team hopefully has control of at that point. Yaka's gonna go for a quick spawn peek. Good throwback there to Waka all the way back in the day.
Hollow is going to be tough to make that work, unfortunately.
I mean, you'd be surprised, man. Waka all the way back, SI 2019, John. Little Valkyrie gameplay. What you know about that, huh?
Kendrick gets us started, though. Yaga tries to jump out yet again, and Kendrick finds that consistency curse a little bit there. As we do see Spirits trade him back out now. It just goes 1-1 on this run. Spirits, hard hold on the corner right there. Oh, man. Does not suspect the big swing from Astro. And he'll be able to get two. And down against him, Kino responds with two of his own. It's a battle of superstars here. Players just going off, back and forth against each other. Slevin, a great opportunity, but he can't follow through with the spray. Kino survives and only loses about a third of his health as we are already down to a 2v2, less than a minute into the round.
Both of these teams, so feisty.
It's a gunner's game right now.
Yeah, a lot of fire back and forth. Frag grenade in. Could get rid of that castle barricade there, give them some access to vents. They still have Groovy here on the nook, so this could be extremely useful for them. No frag grenades on him, but drone for Slevin, but probably on flank. As they do still have two active, but obviously three dying in some pockets, so a little hard fought there for Team Secret, but hopefully have something. You can see Astro's on a camera, it's Slevin, so I'll be helping them out. So more than likely be a camera that's not moving much unless they need it. Try and clear out sight. I'm gonna try and use the verticality to their advantage and see if they can potentially get a pickup. M80, I don't think, though, is going to be playing this directly onto sight. They'll be playing right on the outskirts. Very, very smart thing to do. Try and defend some of these positions. The stairwell as well as the drop. And you see that drone from Slevin. They had it upstairs inside the 90 hallway. They're gonna work that downstairs, John. I'm gonna try and get that in sight, but DS is gonna clean that up.
Activating presence reduction.
Grubby starts the descent here. Just gonna go slightly unnoticed. So wraps around the corner, keep in mind. It's got this more obscured footsteps nicely found as well. Dios not ready for it on the cross. Kino finds the response though. Yet again, one player goes down, another star seems to rise. Slevin, he'll go for the plant. Here's Kino's second opportunity for the clutch. He's gonna miss Slevin initially. Here's another transition! Oh! And gets the instant headshot. It's another 1v1 clutch going the way of M80 as they sustain and keep the lead in their pocket.
Gotta wipe my glasses off here. Is that an audio fake in Rainbow Six? Disgusting. I was watching Counter-Strike there for just a split second. Oh my, Kino. Look at that. Gets it lined up. First bullet out of that MPX. 5 rounds now for M80, as every single round seems like it's up in the air. Anybody's ball game between these two teams. Absolutely loving it, especially for Team Secret. Really good to be seeing them play so well. Been loving what we're seeing from Astro. Some big, big kills from him. Just haven't been able to build off it in the best of ways for Team Secret. It's been a lot of M80 just being like, all right, cool. If you can do that, we can do that as well. And they end up equalizing.
So for Team Secret, it's once again a task of getting back on the seesaw here. See if they can swing themselves up high enough to tie things up with 5-5, or does M80 really take control after yet another ground-shattering clutch comes into their favor there? Down to the 1v1, truly becoming a game of individuals to a lot of this for a lot of these rounds here, because it ultimately just comes down to a 1vx more times than not. The team doesn't outright dominate inside of the early round. We'll see if things remain as chaotic as they have been for the previous rounds. Keep in mind again what we said there: 8 out of 10 of the players, excuse me, that number's wrong, 6 out of 10 of the players, we're down to a 2v2, were dead inside of the first minute of play in the previous round here. So that gives you an idea of just how hot this game is getting. Quickly.
Spicy. I always love it when these games are this tight-knit. Keep them close, keep them entertaining. I get way, way too bored when things start getting drastic for one team. It's like, all right, come on, man. Let's do something here. And speaking of something, I guess my calls will be answered, won't they? Groovy quickly dispatches Kino. He's like, all right, Stokes. We'll give you some entertainment. Kino goes down. He won't be around to save M80 this time. So they're going to have to rest on the rest of the squad. They've been really, really good, though, being able to play from a man down, not only equalizing, but most importantly, taking rounds from this position quite often.
We're sitting back and waiting here. Astro going for the very safe opening of south, but it is a bit of a distraction as they're actually trying to hop in towards the balcony and take east control, I think, and work things from there. Might not necessarily be the case, though, as we don't see that full commitment showing up from Secret. They're still trying to work some positioning over by the office wall as well. First swing into there, but I mean, he's more than ready for that present. You can see they have the setup to counter that one back out. Secret very much trying to go for the full side swipe clear here. He's trying to move for a full east to west take. Without the corresponding pressure, either coming in from the south or somewhere else on the map, this is still going to be a tough one to make work, even with the time they're trying to give themselves for it. That player advantage is really all they are banking on right now to make this work, and hope they can, the loss of one player, trade their way to a win. And they might very well be right about that. Gomez now being dropped down, not fully eliminated yet. Savage will take some responses. He does go down, but he wins the fight. Yaga gets a confirmation off onto Groovy, but still all these kills are going over to Secret. Astro with 2, Slevin to finish it off. Secret, hold on. We are still tied at 5-to-all.
You can just see how crazy Border is for the offensive side if you're able to get those walls open. A practical kill box. No matter what happened, M80 is entering no man's land. So many angles being flooded on every portion of the map. Fantastic control from them as they break open Archive, have that counter angle coming in from Metal Stairs up through Fountain. Just so many positive areas for them to try and abuse. Really hard fought there from M80 as they can't stop Team Secret from getting control there. That was the biggest issue. Once they have control like that, you just have to try and gun out. And there really wasn't an opportunity for that this time around.
Opportunity indeed, especially with them starting on the back foot. Couldn't really justify any type of hyper-aggressive swings or anything like that to try to get back into the action there, as they were already a player down, so they'd just be risking a further deficit. Tried to play it safe, tried to play to the advantageous spots that they had taken up there in the middle of the round, but does not end up working out. Team Secret is given all the freedom and all the time, more importantly, to read into that and properly execute counter. Armory Archives up on the docket again for M80, as they're still wanting to try and lock in a success on this second floor hold. The Seesaw still alive and well, so it'll be their turn to win it if everything goes in that order. But at the same time, Team Secret giving us a convincing one on that previous round. It's gonna be tough for M80 to turn it back around.
Secret heard you talking mess about Glaz. He's in the lineup and he's here to stay.
What's the over-under on the repick?
Well, they have, what is it, 20 seconds basically remaining until, roughly like 25 seconds at that moment.
I don't think it's going to happen. I think they're going to roll with it.
I think they're going to stick it, yeah.
I think they're going to stick it, considering the way they executed the last round, because those were a bunch of angles where Glaz could actually probably work it pretty well. Like that office play they were trying to make, that's probably like a Glaz playground right there. I think it set that up properly. And more importantly, if M80 actually obliges and swings into it, though, that's the hard part, is you have to convince M80 to actually challenge.
I think the wild thing would be to like do that angle, but set the Wait, hold on one second. Wait, it's gonna be top floor again?
Yeah, it's
they can't use that angle because they didn't bring hard breach. That long angle through archives, they can't use that.
Oh, that's true, yeah.
There's no hard breach there, so the Glaz is gonna have to do something else. Maybe he's gonna go to AC? Oh, now I'm quizzical.
Guess we'll find out.
Oh my goodness.
That was gonna be a real big uh-oh moment when Team Secret gets themselves to the inside.
All right, guys, now use the Somas.
Oh. What Somas?
What Somas, sir?
One in your back pocket.
Oh, thank God it's the weekend. Captain, it's Wednesday.
All right, well, let's see how Team Secret try to get things done here. The Osa as well.
They're going old reliable, baby.
I see how they're
going
to this work now.
Oh. Let's go. Oh, wow. Okay.
And they go.
Love it.
The Osa plant pretty much ready to go already. Kendra has the case in hand.
1, 2, 3 Nitro Cells.
Mm-hmm. There is a direct hard counter to this setup. First smoke, you can see that ball pluming on the ground right there. Phone call's coming too, so that's going to prompt M80 to hold themselves back. Nades cooking in. They want this first kill, I think, before they try to commit themselves to the inside. Once again, possibly waiting for an aggressive swing to come out from M80, but they're holding for the most part. Just a few repositions when they're forced to, but they're not going to be obliging any of this aggression at the moment. Nice nade dump, though. Diaz, though, still staying alive. Oh, the Nitro in another one! A double Nitro! And it's going to knock out Kendru. Drops the case inside of the site. Along with it, that will not be an easy one to retrieve if M80 has an angle on that doorway.
It's the pain train for Kendru, slubbing down to a smoke. Haven't even had the third course of this three-course meal. The Nitro Cell is still in the pocket of Diaz. Very low HP on him, though, but it's a five-man buffet for M80. Practically just throw bodies at Team Secret. It might work out. Yes, with a nice angle. Slevin trying to find him, though. Unless he might be prone inside of that door. They have a lot of time still on the docket to try and abuse. But M80, so healthy. There it is, Spirits. He's going to pick up Savage. They were just waiting to find somebody on rotation. My God, M80. Astro going to get something here at the end. Practically a participation trophy at this moment. It's gonna take a long road in order to get this done. He does have some time, he does have some bullets. Does he have the Kuth? He doesn't. Kino shuts it down, and they have a chance to get this dealt with in regulation.
M80 up to 6. They have a chance indeed, but can they break the curse of the Seesaw that's been alive here this entire half so far? That's the big question now. They're not obviously going to be able to go back to that same site. They're once again going to have to change things up in that regard as well, but they do have some winners now that should be unlocked that they can fall back on. Speaking of which, it's down to Customs here for their final site.
Which, I'm going to confirm this really quickly, but if I do remember off the top of my head, which I've been pretty good at about this this tournament, actually.
Glaz, once again, accomplishing a whole lot in that last round.
Glaz accomplished literally nothing.
I have nothing else to say aside from putting that piece of information out there for those who find that useful.
Care. That's my TED Talk. Thank you for coming. So, what map are we on? No. So, where's Border at here? There we go. 10 plays on Border so far. We've had 114 rounds. It's 46% defender rated. And where was there it is. Oh, we're going to Ventilation Workshop. I'm sorry. I thought we were going down to...
Yeah, we're downstairs.
I thought we were going to Supply and Customs. Apologies. Because we'd only played that 5 times so far, I wanted to get that. So I misheard you. Apologies. But since we're here already, 42% percent defensive win rate on that. 44% actually on Teller's Bathroom, funny enough. So that one just edging out its fellow site. Its sister site, you could say, on the same floor. So... M80 looking to defend vents and do it successfully here. Spirits is going to have a bulletproof up for the outside balcony. Big favorite of mine and a lot of players, honestly. A little bulletproof there. Get so much info as to what's going on out there. And even see the person that's kind of playing around the CCTV window there. It's so strong.
It's not necessarily an easy one to get rid of as well. Definitely going to want to commit a piece of range soft reach utility. If it works, of course, be able to take that down. Hopefully get rid of that piece of vision for M80. M80, in the meanwhile, though, waiting patiently on the depths of the site here, waiting for Team Secret to work their way forward. Keeping a good overwatch onto the site window, just in case Team Secret try to go for something cheekier here. The direct play after what we saw in the previous round. They're certainly wary of it, but at the same time, should be expecting a much more normal execute given the failure that was that direct play from Team Secret in the previous round. Would be a bit bold, in my opinion, to go for something of that nature again. Groovy, though, bit of a bold play of his own, has made a successful insertion over towards Tellers, and at the moment, there's no one really watching out for him, so he does have free reign to move forward and potentially bully his way to controlling the site from the back flank.
Well, it's going to be Secret initially from the vent side, and then it's going to be Kirby rotating in, but that's going to be very easily dealt with by Spirits. They had the comm upstairs that everything was clear and Secret. Not like this, please, please not like this. Three deaths instantaneously, a Thanos snap from M80, and bodies drop left and right. It's up to Slebin. A Rubik's Cube to solve here on Border.
Slebin, last one rolling here, now inside of the 1v4. Siege turns, pretty much infinite time to play this out. That won't really be a big concern for him. It's just everything else that's the problem. He'll have to try and work his way past a lack of intel. A lack of really good angles to work with. Don't even think he has case control realistically close to him. Now it's way downstairs, still sitting on the inside of that doorway from the first plan attempt. So pretty much everything working against this player right now. He'll try to work himself forward. Actually does get the spot onto the player on the inside of the half wall position. There and executes it. Spirits goes down. Three more players to go. Only about a third of his overall remaining time when he got into this situation. Still left here. Trying to establish a bit more of a top down. Oh no, they heard that from the other end of it. Tried the Nitro. He nearly gets one on the way out here. But M80, they're playing this one smart. Very few mistakes being made by them. They back away. They're not going to become a victim of this top down angle. They want Slebin to roll back down to them. Force his hand into another play. And there we go. Kino slaps the last member alive off the seesaw and breaks the curse as they will claim this one in the very final round of regulation. A 7-5 victory for M80 in the first map of the series.
Incredible game there from M80. And not only that, but they didn't need DS to go nuclear there. Amazing game from Kino especially. I believe 12 kills from him. We'll get it confirmed here for you guys. 12-7-1, 11-8-1 for Yaga as well. Both of these two really stepping up when they were needed most.
Meanwhile, over on the side of Team Secret, not the usual issues that we were talking about in the pregame, but we can talk more about that when we come back, ladies and gentlemen. It's map 2. It's coming up right after this break. Stick with us. We got more SI coming up.
I'm Nicholas Morrison, but you know me as Pingu. I'm a two-time Rainbow Six Siege World Champion and former top Rainbow Six Siege player in Pro League. Welcome to my Siege Ranked Bootcamp. We're talking 20 seconds left on the clock. You got the diffuser in hand. What do you do? Play the way that you're comfortable with, because you have confidence when you're in this position. That is when you're gonna be at your very best. Good luck.
Welcome once again, ladies and gentlemen, to the Six Invitational. Getting onward with our third game of the day here on the Alpha Stream. Remember, we've got another game rolling over on the Bravo Stream, too, if you are interested. So feel free to check that out. I think we've got a squad stream rolling if you're watching us on Twitch. And you can feel free to find the affiliated channel on your platform of choice. Away from that, though, map number two of this series is going to be Clubhouse M80. Just barely able to sneak out a regulation win 7-5 as we were stuck in a little bit of a back-and-forth affair throughout most of map number one. Quite a fun one at that, too. Very frag-heavy game. Not too heavy on the strats because it all fell apart pretty quickly. It was about a minute or two deep into the round, turned to raw chaos on quite a few of these. Chaos that, obviously, again, we saw M80 controlling just enough of a majority of to take control of that one at the tail end of regulation.
Yeah, both of these teams like dogs chasing cars. They wouldn't know what to do with one if they just caught it. Agents of Chaos here, it seems, as back and forth we went in border. But now it's down to Clubhouse, a map with a lot more rigidity. Not nearly as many angles you can exploit. There is quite a few on that top floor for like crosses for roamers and stuff like that. But defensively, it is a hallmark of Rainbow Six Siege. So should be a pretty interesting game. Here's the stats on y'all's screens for what we just witnessed on border. A heck of a game, especially from Yaga and Kino.
It is going to be more likely, I think, calm things down a little bit too, moving over to Clubhouse. Not as much room for some of those crazy plays we were seeing out of whoever was on the defensive side, usually starting it out there back over on border. So I'm gonna have to give a little bit more respect to our attackers if you're on the defense this time on the majority of the maps, or majority of the sites, excuse me, anyway. Stats are pretty much what we talked about once again before we went to the break there as well. Yaga and Kino definitely topping things out as far as M80 is concerned, but the rest of the team, no slouches either. And for Team Secret, Groovy actually not giving that huge hero performance that we talked about previously. This could be part of the problem for Team Secret and why they're not finding as much consistent success. Thankfully, there were other players able to step up. Astro, of course, most notably. I felt like Kendrew and Slevin were doing quite the fantastic job as well over the course of that first map.
Well, that will definitely put Astro into a positive KD spread as he was only -3, so good on him. But yeah, Grubby definitely slowing down there. He was +15 prior with a 1.13, and he had a KPR of a 0.91. So really looking for him to try and bounce back. And if he does, then, I mean, we have a serious chance for this to go to overtime, especially with the way that we saw Astro playing there. They just need somebody else that has that dog in them, has that drive. We'll see if they can find it here on Clubhouse. They got to take it to M80. They've been looking feisty. You could say the same about Secret. Just been better in the moment. But M80's moment could be past. Clubhouse could be the time for Secret. We're going to get into the ban phase now and see what's going on.
So Team Secret has the first and final ban. That means the first attacker, last defender. M80 will have the next two coming up here as Montaigne is our first operator to be banned out. Not entirely sure if we had a tendency for M80 to try and pick into him all that much. From memory, I personally don't recall it being a choice of theirs. So this is one more Team Secret thought was just going to come out stylistically. So I'll have to call back on this one a little bit later and see how effective of a ban it was. But this next one, am I wrong? Tell me. Curious now, because I just don't remember M80 being that active on Montaigne on this map.
M80 has played Monty 30%, 30, jeez.
I was about to say, it's a great band, man.
13% of the time overall, but for the map in particular, for Clubhouse, let it proc. It's 22% of the time. So not that bad of a ban. And also, just as a reminder, it's probably pretty successful. Yeah. Yep. I didn't even have to look. It's 100% win rate.
Okay. So, yeah. Play it. Makes sense, though, when you think back on it. I just couldn't remember anything from M80 bringing it up. It's probably happened earlier this event.
Yeah. Well, the thing is that they don't play it all the time because Spirits is so useful on a gun.
Yeah.
But he's also just... he's the worst thing to happen to your team when he's on a shield. Like, you do not want to play into Spirits on a shield. So it's just something they always keep in the back pocket. You know, it's that panic button for M80. So they kind of took away the big red button. There's no emergency stop on this ride anymore for M80.
Maverick, of course, also being banned out there. Kind of a given when you look at Clubhouse, of course, and how useful he is just for this.
You say that, but we, like, never see it anymore.
Occasionally comes out there if the utility facilitates it, but... like you said, there are certainly ways to get the job done anyway, especially with Thatcher being left in. They can just use any combo of Hard Breacher and him and get the job done anyway. For Secret, though, that is going to leave quite a few fun operators open for the picking. Specifically, Solace now activated specifically for Savage on this round. So we're going to see her cause amok, specifically when it comes to the drone game for the players over on M80.
All right. Well,
nicely done.
So it's going to be the second time that M80 has banned out Maverick this tournament for Clubhouse.
Three drones sniped, by the way, during that prep phase because of Savage's pick.
Man, I love solos.
One was like outside the building too. I think you were looking at your tablet when it happened there. But he just like popped the front door because he saw the icon coming. It was like, oh, right into the car. You don't get to have a drone anymore.
It's you know what the worst thing
you
is.
You just can't put a drone by like a window or anything.
You can't do anything because here's the thing. Even when all of your teammates like position drones away from her, and then you all have to flip over to the person that parked their drone outside so the other drones don't die, they still turn on for a split second while you're flipping through. So Solas can still find the drones. Oh my goodness, she is just such a crazy operator, man. She is wild. By the end of this tournament, I can almost guarantee she's gonna have like an upward percentile of like 98% pick and ban, which is probably gonna be insane. Kendru though, with our opening pick, DS to quickly fire back, Slevin to go down. M80, they found some traction here in the mud. Yaga, and take down another secret. Seems like the extension of the same story. Part two here. Nice shots though from Astro. And yes, indeed, we are having an extension, aren't we, John? It's down to Grubby. Been asking him to step up to the plate, get something done here. He's found two inside of the bathroom. Gets one, almost gets that transfer. Nade out. Well, my disc out as well. They know Gomez still has a nade tucked in his pocket. Gonna challenge him with a case here.
Play from Grubby. Coming back towards the site, but Gomez reads into that possibility. Keep in mind, he's still got that second nade. You heard it click. Trying to force Grubby back here out. By clicking that, it will work. Gives him a few seconds of free time, but Grubby being kind of loud as he stomps forward. Not quick enough, though. The peak timing is there, but there's cover as well for Gomez to play behind. The spam affecting both players, and Gomez full commits. It'll lead to a successful round for M80 as they're on the board first again here by picking up the opening round.
The confidence in these players right now on both teams. Sticking to these gunfights. They want these kills. They're out for blood. And every time it's boiling down to these one-on-one, one-on-twos. Both these teams getting some 1vXs under their belts as well. Oh my goodness.
I thought we were going to see more respect for the defenders. I talked about it there in the pregame. Turns out I was dead wrong. I'm wrong about a couple things this series. Not about glass, though.
Yeah, yeah. No, about that. No glass. It's you can have anything as long as it's not glass.
As long as it's not a glass.
We'll see if that's an ongoing theme this entire tournament. It might be. We might get all the way to the main stage, John. You and I are casting the quarterfinals. It's the last dying moment.
It's definitely going to be like a glass play wins the tournament now or something like that.
Oh, they would never let you live that one.
Yeah, no. They could tweet it like 30 times probably.
Halfway through the group stage, you're like, glass is the worst thing ever to happen in existence. He wins out the three most crucial rounds in the grand final.
It's going to happen. It's just my luck. 5 seconds. Oh, we've got M80 with their selections locked in. No repicks showing up for them. Pretty straightforward attacking lineup as well for this type of map here. Pretty much just your basic composition. Double hard breach as well as a little bit of a security measure. But away from that, Team Secret going for a bit more delay here as they'll add the Vulcan canisters in there for Kendru. Does still enable him to play things out a bit more aggressively as well, since obviously all of his utilities pre-placed before the round begins. So you'll be free to roam about here and hold currently a very aggressive blue position.
Indeed. Kendru's going to be playing on Secret Stairs. I don't really have the ability to suss him out unless they want to commit to drones or maybe run a Yana clone in there right now. So just got to be aware if they cross that open window that there's some potential for a player to be around. Astro's going to hold things down on the top of Cash. Also have Ruby in the area. So we'll see what they can get done with this. Constantly flickering back and forth on that Solas utility. See if we can find some drones or anything else in between. Just trying to slow down the offensive front of M80. Spirits with a nice cross angle here. Always been so monstrous on this buck. Saw the head, flashbang in. Also shots more than likely came from another angle. Very well done from M80. All that pressure on the top floor. Astro feels as though he can just freely rotate around, but obviously not. M80 have every avenue shut down.
M80 once again, not really giving Team Secret a whole lot of valid aggressive options. Ruby trying to get out into the open for another engagement, just full commits to it. Would have needed to slap the head off of his opponent, but it does not happen. Slevin finally responding back, but unfortunately his self-destructed wall is going to be open in the process of that. Yaga takes down not only him, but Savage as well. Suddenly, only halfway through the round, Kendru is left alone here with a single trade to work off of. A 1v4 now set before him, along with a little bit of damage onto Yaga.
All right, Kendru. Not a single one of these situations has ended normally, so I expect a lot out of you here. in the hallway.
It's got to go down to at least a 1v1.
Yeah, exactly. M80 needs to give up three bodies here, and it starts with this vertical peak. Oh, no, on the stairs, maybe. Oh, can do a lot of damage. Run back through. Nobody manning the holes. I'm actually a little surprised there. He drops Kino. How big brain. Oh, my. That's not even off the audio. That's just off of him having some solid game sense. He just used that breaching charge. No ears on anybody when those things go off.
Potentially got a call from his teammate that he had just been over by main stairs, making the call out that, yeah, he's probably just staying super mobile here. There's no way he's actively watching my angle, so I'll go for the drop. And it ends up being a very smart call. Secret with an incredibly early timeout here, only two rounds deep, and already they feel the need to back themselves out of the round, recenter it, and figure out what's going wrong. End up being valid here is these are very one-sided rounds in comparison to what we had played out in the previous map alone here. So it's good that we're seeing the coach's input being made now. An attempt to recenter this before it gets out of control.
Breathe.
Play together.
Play together.
It's like
I liked Twister, I love you, but I liked Leon's earlier a lot more. You know what he said?
What?
I don't care how stupid it is. Let's just play together and it'll work. It doesn't matter if it's stupid, it matters if it works.
I mean, it sounds very simple, but it's correct at the end of the day. M80 is playing things incredibly individualistically right now. It's all like solo players making their own moves. If Team Secret makes moves, even as like duos.
Yep.
In worst case, just trade it back out. Bring it back down to these bare-knuckle brawl fights, basically, in a worst-case scenario. And you're going to pretty much get a guarantee of that just by grouping up a little more.
Welcome to the church, John. If you play as a team, you win as a team and you lose as a team. You know, it's a really important factor to Rainbow Six Siege. You can get so much done, even if it's a silly thing. You know, if you drop five people down the same hatch, the opposing team still has to deal with five people going down the same hatch, you know? So with that in mind, you can do a lot more than you think that you can in Siege. Sometimes the most safe, most fundamental thing doesn't win you a game. And that's mostly what they're focused on right now. Secret needs to play together, need to fall back on their squad, and try and take these fights as a squad. That's mostly what Twister was touching on. And obviously, again, the Leon format, I don't care if it's stupid, just do it together, and it'll more than likely work. So, we'll see if Secret can abide by these laws of Rainbow Six going into round three. Only 30 seconds off the clock here, but we know that's all dedicated towards drones. Tends to be the way of Siege laws, as we were just talking about. Nice angle there from M80 down towards the main stairs. This might be super scary to try and fight for Slubbin. Nitro Cell out, but Spirits, he's got that all the way back, like over the top of billiards. Absolutely disgusting stuff he's got going on here. Constantly taking these fights, working these angles back and forth, seeing if he can get somebody to step up in an improper manner. Astro, what are you doing?
That's not together.
Head on your shoulders. Oh no, it was two together, that's a thing. He thought he was safe because his friends were down there. No.
They got their own thing going on. You're just a third wheel in that arrangement, Astro.
You forgot about the 102nd degree angle in that tiny little box.
You gotta find your own buddy, Astro.
Exactly.
All right, well, he's unfortunately going to get caught off there, trying to make the transition back down through main stairs. What a dash from Gomez. Had the yellow ping from his teammates to prompt it as well, so knew exactly where to place that crosshair. Beautifully done. That's experience right there, paying off hugely for the M80 roster. The nades are going to be working their way forward, trying to take full control of blue.
Attackers have dropped the bomb diffuser.
Well, Secret, although Twister stops the match, tries to give him some help, John. A lot of individualistic things happening here. Past the main stairs, just an awkward angle. Ken Drew, I gotta slow this down. He's gonna try and go for the refrag.
You're like getting annoyed now.
Don't say that. Don't let him know. Don't let him know, John. Oh, he can sense the tone of my voice. 1v5, 1v4 now for Slevin. Make it a 1v3, potential 1v2. Almost gunned down Gomez. You should have stayed on the trigger there. Back and forth. Gomez gonna get tagged up again. Knows he's probably playing on black box here. Very common angle. Where else, I mean, is Slevin gonna push? I think he's got somebody playing inside of his moto as well here, potentially. Nope. He's gonna be playing on the bottom of main stairs instead, and lots of damage going off into Slevin now. Has the impact to try and fight for Kool-Aid, but no, it's gonna be Diaz that takes him down. And M80 cleaned it up.
Little child, You are so bad!
Bro, there was three people filing me on those.
It was cut off as rocks.
I was on gym match, you know, like the ink?
No, no.
So once again, that clutch scenario just not winnable ultimately at the end of the day. Asking Slevin to do way too much inside of that scenario.
I just want to touch on that little moment there just because obviously M80 leaned back into it. I really don't understand why Astro feels safe there, and I don't understand how Secret can't translate that somebody is playing the verticality directly above you. That seems like something at this level that you should be able to do. I'm just putting that out there. That's a little bit too far-fetched for me personally. But, I mean, it seems like they're starting to split the seams right now, John. Entering free fall three rounds from M80 on the offensive side. Secret no longer having attack timeout either to try and slow up this ship.
Already that 3-0 lead established. Quite a dominant one here for Clubhouse as well. See it go in such an attacker-favored way here. Not the way that Team Secret would have liked to start this map out, especially considering that at least the first one, relatively close. We could have been looking at things a little bit differently here now had they been able to maintain control over that situation in the first round, but they've been unable to do so. And it's really only gotten worse since then, even with the pause coming back. Did not really serve to change up the team's fate all that much by stacking together for that main stairs push. So we'll have to see what else is in the cards for Secret as they move into their fourth round now, their fourth defense, running low on time to make some big impact on this half.
Top floor defense here for Team Secret. Slubbin hoping somebody was going to face check the hatch, but nothing doing for Spirits. Getting that open for a later time. Usually the first thing you get done when you do get to the roof as the soft destruction. Easy pickings here for Diaz, and he's just going to escape. Nitro Cell out. It doesn't even deal any damage due to the place that it landed. The Jacuzzi is going to soak up all of that there. Make it much harder for M80, or rather Team Secret now. It's a lot of this utility already flying very wide of M80.
Disabling electronics.
We're going to see M80's first attempt to work their way back in through the breach that's been made over on Jacuzzi. It's an attempt to take down that hard breach there from Kendra, but it's a little bit late. He's still gonna end up losing his mirror window. Now a very difficult position to play into. Savage has been able to fend off the first real bit of aggression, but it's way over in Garage that he gets that angle, potentially through that cash window to be able to deploy it there. Never mind, it might have been direct contact as M80 is trying to put some of their own players on this part of the map as well to push in from an alternate direction. They still have a minute and a half to work this. They've not been able to find any immediate success in trying to push their way in through Jacuzzi, so they're trying to establish an alternate angle from the cash side as well.
Slow and steady now for M80. Lost Gomez earlier on, and this has been the biggest chance that Secret has had for a round, minus the one-on-one engagement that we saw. Be patient, play this one together. Advising. Twister talked about earlier, just trying to make sure that they can maintain their advantages. Diaz and Groovy are gonna trade here. Big trade as well. That's gonna be the Thermite down, out for the Aruni. M80 not in the advantageous position just yet, but looking to try and gather back some land. Have some nice crosses established here. Worried about logistics office, and they rightfully should be. Plenty of bodies for Team Secret to be around this area, and they are. Have an interesting one coming here. Kendru, what a shot, taking so many bullets. If he wasn't a three armor, he'd surely be dead, but fortunately for him, alive and well.
Big moves from Kendru here. And maybe still struggling to pick up the pieces and make up the difference now as they are finally on the wrong side of this coin. Spirits finding one. Keep in mind, Kendru's still low, so if he's trying to hard commit himself into the next fight, he could find himself only helping to equalize out the situation as well. He'll have to play this very carefully. 15 seconds left. What an angle from Slevin here. Goes completely unnoticed by the initial peek, and Astro comes in to overwhelm the last player standing. Finally, Secret's now on the board.
And that's a team play that Twister was looking for right there. The patience inside of logistics is what wins them that match. So very well done in that round as they finally get one on the board, but it's going to take a lot of heavy lifting on this defensive side now. M80 have already guaranteed a perfect half with this. Nice pickup there from Secret, though. Definitely slowed down M80, although more towards that middle part of the round. You can see Spirit starting to collect himself. Start working the mat there from construction. Getting the ball rolling, but the rest of the team not there exactly to assist. Love the active gameplay there from Kendru as well, playing right on the cusp of alerting the opposition of him being outdoors, right on the breach, able to catch one of the unsuspecting M80 members dropping off to the side of the building.
Wow, Well, we've got the players from M80 winding up for another go at it. It is going to be another basement hold attempt from Team Secret as well, making a return over towards that. M80 has been able to take it on both of the attempts played out so far. Probably a little bit relieved we're heading back down there, not in any new territory. As Team Secret once again is going to try something a little different this time. They will commit further into this extension. We'll have Capcan traps potentially supporting it as well. Legion Goo Mines also possibly helping out to keep this extension alive for a bit longer, trying to waste out that time bank and prevent these basement dissensions from being so successful, as we've seen two times in a row now from M80.
Logic bombs now for Yaga Gomez. On the Yana, or logic bomb is now for Yaga, right? Yana now for Gomez. EMP's out here for Yag. Nitro cell, and it's gonna at least be able to get a drone, so got something there, but not exactly the whole pie. Kino's drones out, looking for a little bit of info on this top floor. This is where the clear is gonna start coming through for M80 for this basement defense. Secret looking to get aggressive, but we saw how easily M80 cleared out these top floor positions prior, and they've got a lot of utility to try and do so yet again. Another logic bomb in the pocket of Yaga, past the one that is currently active. Still have stuns, nades, and everything but the kitchen sink available to M80, minus Kino now that Slevin has gotten him. A nice play here from Groovy. And that's going to be all she wrote for Secret on this top floor. They're going to dislodge themselves, shake it down to the basement floor.
Happy with the two kills they've picked up and relatively minimal damage that they received in the process of that. Yaga and the rest of M80 continue to group up, see what they can still possibly work towards here. A slow clear even to areas like stock as they just now move into the building and the all clear to make a dissension. One piece of hard breach remains as well in the pocket of DS. He does have some potential supporting EMPs to help out with that. But thankfully, not going to have to worry about anything on the other side of these walls. No mute, no bandit, and of course, no Cade in play. So he's going to have freedom to pop open whatever he would like. If the team finds time to do it, of course, that'll be the big problem. They're probably spending the majority of this remaining time trying to explore their options. Hopefully drone things out as well, a little bit deeper into the site to find the correct path forward. Well, at the moment, it looks like an attempt to directly contest against some of the pressure coming out from M80 by this main stair spot. Gomez chucks in a nade to respond to that nitro that had been thrown at him just a few seconds prior. Also, of course, would have dealt with any utility behind that wall had there been any. No significant damage onto any players at this point, and that's the big problem. There's no clean path forward past the main stairs entry point. So how exactly does M80 look to move in and take control with just 25 seconds to go now?
Time is stretching.
Oh, so
interstellar here for M80 right now. Got to try and get their way down this hatch, John, but it's nigh impossible. Savage is gatekeeping them right now. Stuns in, and he's got the perfect placement for the drop. Other person, oh, slipped right past him, but doesn't really matter. Slevin's got such a strong cross, and there's so many bodies for Secret that we'd have to have another mistake like we had on Border in order for M80 to win that round. So well done from Secret there. One more round, John, and they can actually equalize here. It was not looking too hot just two rounds ago.
The run back, though, is alive and well. M80 a lot quieter all of a sudden here. Now they need to focus up and get the final round of the half to try and make sure they can at least solidify the advantage here. After everything is considered, a 3-0 start about to turn into, as Stokes mentioned there, a 3-3 half. M80 probably not going to be happy with that, given the way that this started out. It'll be a new site on the board finally for Team Secret as well, entering the final round. Bar stage is up on their final pick. You see, once again, the Mozzie to try and deny drone intel. The castle create a little bit of a maze that M80 will have to work their way through. And the bandit to try and deny a few of these wall openings as well. Extend the upstairs hold for a little bit longer, more than likely.
It's not a fun maze. Not a very fun maze. Probably the most hated maze in all of Siege. I take that back, Villa. Definitely Villa. That Villa basement, it's bane of everybody's existence. We haven't got to cast much Villa this event either, which it kind of sucks, man. I really like
it. I think we
Villa.
Did already do like all the maps though, which is actually like pretty impressive for the stage of the tournament.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely.
Armite takes us like pretty deep to like do all of them. So I think we had our like all the maps done in like the first like 2 to 3 days. So.
Yeah, I think overall a lot of teams just more comfortable with all the maps now because we've had the 9 map pool for so long. there for a while, like, you know, perfect example, Sonics. And I think, if I remember correctly, it was Cafe that they banned out for such a very long time. And that was one of the reasons, is because, like, you just have so many maps to work on and try and keep up with all at that same time that, well, if we're working on all of these other ones, then let's just, you know, bookshelf one. Wait till we have all of these improved. So, looks like people are starting to be a lot more comfortable with this full map pool.
And well, we have got the players from M80. I'm trying to go for the quick opener here. Slevin is actually, no, wrong window, unfortunately. He is gonna be able to stop the second panel from being breached. Interrupts the Selma, but the big one there, that one's gonna go through irregardless. So an opening is made. Still two more Selmas to be used as well. Impact Trick does do a little bit of self-damage there to himself, but more importantly, does knock out the utility. And of course, Kendrew striking first in the kill marker this time, able to successfully knock out Gomez.
Well done to them for that. Gomez has been able to find some very influential kills so far, but these opening bloods might come back to bite them. Seems like time and time again with these winning rounds from Secret that he is the butt of the joke. Spirits is going to start breaking up the CCTV wall. They're going to leave Kino over here on post. They're going to assume the exact same position, but on the other side of the map, over here towards the east. Works his way in towards CCTV. Be a little bit more active than obviously what we're going to see from Kino is he's simply the anvil for the hammer to come through for M80. Spirits is going to continue to process his top floor with Yogg. DS more than likely on cam. Indeed, as he is indeed on the roof. So to be expected, Kino a little too active there as he continues to search for new angles and he's going to squander his life away. Two big kills here for Secret. That's exactly what they wanted. And even bigger factor that, M80 just now got here. They're just now at the party to be able to try and assist him off the back of a swing like that. Yaga will get a big kill here. Diaz trying to work his way in from the breach on the opposite side. Nice little angle, he's discovered one. He'll take down Savage. They're gonna open up the round. Is there any Nitros downstairs though? Big Nitros, actually. Astro with two big kills as well. It's gonna be up to Diaz. Has so much to do here with 30 seconds remaining.
And 1v3, unfortunately, not the best odds. Default Cam already spotting him, trying to make a push over towards main stairs. It is a very obvious play for Team Secret to counter at. Now they just need to be patient. Point this one down. More importantly, you can see the case still out in the open there, too. One little dirty peek from Slevin. Finishes off the job. And indeed, Secret bring it back now. Tie us up at 3-1 at halftime.
That's all with you, lads.
You're not going to be able to execute.
So, actually, very, very happy that we kind of let that last little bit of audio through there. Did you catch what he said?
Not really. I heard that that's how we do, lads. That's about it.
Well, it wasn't from Team Secret, actually. It was from M80. And I think it was Spirits, but he said, don't worry about it. They're not going to be able to execute.
That's a true possibility, that's for sure.
Potential.
Mm-hmm. We have to wait and see how these first few rounds go to get a better judge of that. M80 could very well be regretting those words. Things do not pan out for them in these first few rounds. The lead will immediately dissipate. They lose even just this one. So the heat is on. The pressure is on for M80 to test that belief that Snoke's caught on to. What's up?
Clubhouse is at a 59% defensive win rate right now. So that is not looking too hot for Secret. If what M80 comes to fruition, makes it even more difficult for them. We'll have to see what they can get done here. Let's look at the lineup, John. What do they bring into the table? Bringing a lot of hard breach. I'm interested to see if Savage is going to have secondary hard breach on top of this as well. Wow. Okay. This is the triple down.
You want to open up everything, man.
Even past that, usually when you see this, it means that everyone is looking to fight somebody. Nobody has to worry about anything, minus the Savage a little bit because he's the main soft breach as well, so you really want him to like be able to break up like the kitchen hallway and stuff like that because those angles are so abusable. They're fantastic if you can get control of them.
Reloading. All right, well, we'll see if Secret is able to control the chaos, so to speak, here. If they try to play things out in that same nature. See Gomez, prime of the Nitro, ready to chuck one out towards blue. If there's going to be pressure on the window, but not leaning his direction. They're going to be trying to open up different parts of the map first. Savage hoping for a rotation back through construction and through the main stairs as well, where he'd be able to get a slight glimpse and a slight shot off of the players moving through there, but no one in the neighborhood at the moment here for our M80. They are long gone. No real extension whatsoever. They're playing heavily into the bunker this time.
Secret's still taking their time, though. Not want to let M80 slip through the cracks and potentially get some big kills that could be round-defining. Sullivan's going to work his way in towards Grodz. Claymore up the ladder. So far, so good for Secret on this clear, but obviously M80 not having too much to say when it really comes down to it so far. It's about to be the time where they can influence things. Lots of drone work inside of the first minute and a half, and now it's time to the nitty-gritty. Soft breach as well as everything else in between. Still need to get the kitchen hatch open. They're going to be able to get bar open here as well, and Savage in for the assist on the skeleton key for this space.
Attempt to potentially try and open up the kitchen hatch. Going to be coming through. More likely be stemmed. Oh no, the electric wall going to be a little slow. Heard it going off there, but that's like a counter out by the secret rosters. They already have that primary hatch open back up. Moto has been slapped open too. So secret moving right along schedule here, but they do need to get into the execute phase quickly now as we are entering the 1 minute mark. And this one takes a while to make happen.
Yes, indeed. And now remember, M80 said, Secret cannot execute. Do not worry about it. Well, they've got the position for it. They've gotten the kill on Yogg. We'll see if what they said is true. Kendra's going to rotate back over towards stock. Look like they might try and have some influence over on the blue side. Frag grenade out. They're going to try and keep M80 guessing. Nitro cell out. Big pickup on to Groovy. This might be the chance for them to slow things down.
Drop in from Astro to make the big play, but he's got the wrong target. Gomez sneaks through, takes him down instead with the shotgun. Kendra, though, still in the same position to plant. They have not been able to stop him. They will take him down immediately as he leaves the plant position, however. No longer a great support available here for the post plant. Yeah, you've got the player upstairs with Overwatch on it, but Slevin not necessarily in a workable position for it. If they get past him, they only have that top down to rely upon here, but M80 still giving quite a bit of respect over to that at the moment here. They're not aware, I don't think, of Slevin, and here we go! Two in the hallway! They didn't know someone descended through main stairs. He gets away with the double. It's a 1v2 set before him now. Direct support is on the plant angle. Slevin trying to work it here with the pistol, but no! The bars block his way, and M80 wins out the first round of the second half.
Hello? You good, guys?
Well, to be fair, they did execute. And they did get a plant down, so tally towards Team Secret? You gotta be the ref here.
Who really wins that round? That's the big question.
No, I need to know who has the moral victory. Who cares about the actual round win? Who gets the tally?
I mean, I guess M80, right? Because I still give it to M80.
Okay, all right, fair enough.
Like, that was like, M80 kind of let that plant happen. I feel like they had an idea that like, all right, Kendra's going to get this plant, but he's not staying alive. The second he moves out from it, he's a dead man. And I feel like that's a pretty correct assumption. It was just took him a little while to get past the top down. I think they thought both players were up there, and that's what they were worried about.
Yeah.
That's why they were taking it so slowly. That's why it was so close in the first place, because they just didn't catch the player down main stairs, basically.
Fair enough, fair enough.
Is that analytical enough for you?
10 seconds to go. It'll do.
I'm the play-by-play, so.
Yeah,
my analysis is allowed to be bad.
No comment. So M80 gonna pick up that round first. Defensive success. Team Secret, though, I mean, run into a few problems there on the tail end. You know, all things said and done, I still like what Slevin was able to accomplish there. I just really, really sucks that he really didn't have the greatest, acquirement of his target. Through
a little slower there on those pistol shots.
Yeah, a little slow. Definitely not the fastest gun in the West, I can tell you that.
All right, well, things are abounding yet again. M80 with the advantage, but can they keep it? It's no expansion there. That was a pretty close one. Team Secret, turns out they can execute pretty well at the end of the day there and was able to work a plant in pretty quickly. The MP goes in. Just to ensure that this wall is opened up. More importantly here, that this Candela will go through to stop the blockage. Over by Red Hull allows for a very quick push, but the Toxic Babe is blocking the way. Savage still got away with at least one pick here, but another one aside from that is going to be hard to find. Astro now down at the hands of Dios. No plant can be set up here at the moment for Team Secret. Those Toxic Babes, they weren't really counting on them being positioned so well, and as a result, they have to give up this pursuit for now.
Oh, man. You could see the comms devolve actively on your screen right there. As Astro just dives so deep into the site, everyone has been gatekept by the smoke outside. Savage breathing in so much of the toxic fumes. Low on HP. He's going to have to try and maintain the repelled position and hope that M80 are willing to try and give something up here. Someone's going to move in for Garage. Groovy going to continue to hold the ladder room. Try and hold Oil Pit here. M80, though, I think they're going to rest. Just like they did the last round, let Secret try and set up a bit here. Punish him for it.
Clement and Kendrick trying to make this garage play work with even further support from Groovy down below at the bottom of those garage stairs. Over a minute, so again, Secret are not really struggling for a lack of time. It's the same back in the last round as well here. It's just the actual execute that is evading them and the intel that is necessary to get the strength needed to make these pushes happen. It seems like they are in a prime position to go for it, though. As they move towards it, however, we see an explosive do some pretty serious damage over towards Kendrew. Tries to go for the plant kick.
Oh, Yogg running
as well. Yogg going for a nitro.
Oh my god!
It's a little deep, but it gets the job done. Dios as well as Kino shut down the majority of the garage hold. Grubby, who is supposed to be flank Overwatch, now the only player left in this. Great instant exchange from him against Dios, but still three players to go. This is where the benefit of time comes in to help him a little bit here, as he does have some of it. So work out inside of this clutch, but you can see he's just guessing on the angles right now. No confirmed intel to play off of. He's got the right read on that player in red, but beyond that, it's going to be tough to work this clutch out. A surprise jump downs that player, but Kino made the dash across the divide in the meanwhile, and he'll be the one to shut it down.
Wax on, wax off for Kino. Easy moves there for the smoke player. And that's two tallies going towards M80. The first one kind of up in the air, that one definitely definitive as they completely box Secret out of their execute.
Much more definitive hold that time as well, and showing the struggles for Team Secret's execute that M80 was probably talking about there when we caught their comms at the edge of the half. M80 gonna go back over to Bar here for this one as well. Final point on their rotation more than likely, so do not expect a gym unless they need to sneak it out here. And we see a few repeat victories from Secret where they feel that's necessary. Basement will more than likely be the next site on round 10. Especially if this one gets locked away.
Well, this has been a treat so far between these two. Secret kind of slowing down, though, on this offensive side here on Clubhouse. Border was neck and neck all the way through till M80 finally gathered control to barely eke it out before overtime dawning on us. Now for Secret, looking to see if they can try and force a similar path here. M80 still one round away from guaranteeing overtime, but that doesn't mean that Secret can't make some progress. Still some potential to take this in regulation as well, if you want to look at it from that lens. They only need four in a row, but I mean, if you ask me, it's a little optimistic, but hey, still there.
Well, once again, the action begins and Team Secret is out onto the board. One of their first adventurers take them. Hopefully not too close to our friend hiding behind the peephole here in the jacuzzi wall. Because we do have a setup here from Yaga. We're gonna try and get in the way of Team Secret immediately from the clear, but more likely not gonna be met with too much of a challenge. Secret's focus is in a different part of the map right now, trying to move over into Cash. Take that away from M80 instead.
M80's gonna extend things out towards the strip side. Very smart positioning here. What the hell's gonna be Dios over there? I thought they had a smoke in play just for a split second. But nope, a lot of longer range guns here, a lot of 1.5s, four of them in fact. Yaga is the only one without, as Alibi had lost hers recently. MX4 Storm performing a little over what the capacity that Ubisoft looks at it for. So decided to take that magnified sight off. Won't be that big of a deal, though. Still one of the most played operators on the defensive end, even past that. So, just an amazing gun when it comes down to it. Fantastic reads here from Dios, and Astro not aware of this Yokai drone constantly hopping up and down directly to the side of him. A grenade in that almost gets the big kill. They're going to find Astro up top. Logic bombs out, and that actually might be a cam. Some nice kills here from Kendrew. The frag might on full display, but the shotgun will put him down. Another person home. It's going to be Spirits that goes down there. I catch my breath for a split second. I thought Savage ended up getting bodied at that range, but no, he will stave off. Yeah, he will stave off elimination, but you can't say the same about Slevin as Kino finds him from the hatch.
Savage, of course, still reeling from the previous damage done to him, so it's going to be difficult for him to try and set up for anything hyper-aggressive while trying to play headshot angles, more than likely, if he has a choice in the matter. Groovy, in the meanwhile, he's on a case retrieval 2D, as apparently someone left it back on the roof, so they've got to go back to grab that real quick. They do feel that the territory's open enough now to maybe make a play for this one. But at the same time, the defense still pretty heavily centered over here towards Strip. We do see, of course.
That's that Yokai that got eaten by that logic bomb.
Mm-hmm. So inadvertently kills it, but a kill is a kill nonetheless. He does still have the second one, though. I saw it roaming around. It's currently positioned somewhere in the site. So
stage, it's right over here on the roof. Got a bulletproof there as well. Case in Savage's hand. Savage, the low HP one. Very easy to tag him up and get that case to stop. Looks like he wants to potentially maybe drop, cause some audio. He faked them out, but that's the thing. Long range, and Savage has such low HP, they didn't even consider this when looking into what potentially could have happened here. A nice shot, but now all that has to happen, Kino has to play time. 4 seconds. 5 seconds. Kino's just gonna
Kino's just running. He's like, I don't even want it. Oh, the drop shot.
Oh. Yeah, no, that was very scary.
To be fair, yeah, we're seeing it on the kill cam now. Kino was worried about him potentially coming down Moto Hatch as well, so that's why he turned back around and ended up running directly into him. A little bit of a scary moment for Kino, but as we've seen through multiple times in this series, multiple rounds as well, he's been able to handle that.
I hope we get to show that last little kill there from his perspective, because one of my friends does this all the time. We actually got to see, like, Kino's Pav. He didn't even aim. He just proned and shot. And I swear, there's just some people in Siege that have like this fairy dust sprinkled on them where magical crap happens to them all the time. And one of my friends is this exact way. I can never get stuff like this to happen to me. I always have to struggle, John.
Wasn't it like Doki that had like a Maru hop in the other day or something else on G2 as well? Or it was just like a straight hip fire instant headshot? Like,
no, he just kicked him in the face via the Gaara hook. That was it. Yeah. Just no gun needed. Just a flying drop kick from outside the building. They should have put the WWE skin on that. That's what they should have done. Oh my gosh. I don't even remember somebody that could fit into that. All my WWE characters are very, very old.
Yeah,
I watched during like Kelly Kelly and all that.
I'm not too big on WWE.
Yeah, I'm sure Jacob could talk to us at nauseam about that. Which I'm perfectly okay on, Jacob. I love you.
Well, we've got M80 up on map point and a heck of a lot sooner than they were able to achieve it back on map number one for Border as well. A single round to go. And three attempts to get it now. Team Secret reels from the issues.
Didn't get this one earlier, but might get it now.
Problem is that barricade is still slapped shut. No easy way to pop it back open just as of yet here. Slevin seemingly ready for the challenge on the other end of it too, so it's not going to be any guarantee he can deploy this utility, especially now that a drone has been able to spot him back out. You're going to see a different form of explosive go up top. That's just going to be, of course, the main balcony being open, and oh no, Slevin baits into it, goes for the duel, thinks he has the drone intel, but it's Gomez with a TCSG that'll grab him instead. Not the start that Secret needed here at all.
Snatch Slevin's soul right out of his body. Now Secret down for the count here, at least down by one. Got the entire top floor to themselves, John. Not too much to worry about in that degree, but the biggest issue is now is when it comes down to the execute. Spirits is set up for the Electro Shuffle because they know that Slevin plays Thatcher. That is ludicrous. There's no pocket EMPs either. These hatches are stuck. Although I do believe that is unbeknownst to M80 at this point. Still the potential here for them to try and get something going on. Plenty of hard breach at their disposal still, but as long as there are some parameters for M80 to work around to deny this, this is a fairly straightforward round for them.
Half the round still to go though, so Secret left once again. Has it made a point of death battle here? With plenty of time still to make this execute happen.
There we go.
That's the big trade we needed to see. Savage working it down through oil pit. Unexpected push from the attackers here. Not often you're going to get that, but Gomez solid here in his trades. Another one found. That one's basically Gomez as well, even though Kino gets the credit for it. Spirits will be traded back out.
Ooh.
By Grubby, but Diaz as well finding Kendrew before he can successfully push his way into church. It's all on Grubby, the big man on campus, but not this time, as it's M80 to shut this one down. 7-3 is the final scoreline, a 2-0 victory. And unfortunately, that might be the beginning or already the end for their opponents here, as Team Secret still only with 1 point in the group and just about one match remaining moving into tomorrow.
Another page in the saga of M80 completed. Earlier statements saying, hey, don't really think that Secret's gonna be able to do much on this half, and man, were they true. 7-3. Not dropping a single defensive round there on Clubhouse. Very well done. A complete team effort. Nobody taking the full steering wheel away. Everybody having their moment. Time to shine. Fantastic play here so far from M80 at Six Invitational.
Absolutely the case. Some great play out of the American players on this roster as well, even though he's currently donning the Brazilian cape. Of course, born in Brazil, but resides in America. Kino as well as Yaga. absolutely tearing it up inside of that matchup there. Kino, constant clutch scenarios. Well, he didn't win them all, won the majority of them, and that's what's important. It was Yaga with the big one, of course, back on border. That massive, I think it was a 1v3 set before him there that he was able to close out. Really, really impressive stuff from M80, and more than deserving of the current top position in their group at the moment.
Yes, indeed. It's been a heck of a tournament for them so far, and a great start to the year. You know, the tail end of 2022 wasn't all that great for M80. We didn't get to see them in Yongxiaping, but six invitationals really making up for it.
Yeah, absolutely the case. So the sky's the limit for me as far as M80 is concerned. They have shocked the world so far with their proficient play at this event. Really unimpressive run up until this point, but they had a very long break, and it seems like they have put some serious work in. Will truly be a contender as they work their way through the potential playoff bracket. That'll do it for the two of us right now, ladies and gentlemen. We got a break coming up, and then when we come back, we got the desk ready to break this one down.
I'm Nicholas Morrison, but you know me as Pingu. I'm a two-time Rainbow Six Siege World Champion and former top Rainbow Six Siege player in Pro League. Welcome to my Siege Ranked Bootcamp. We're talking 20 seconds left on the clock. You got the diffuser in hand. What do? Play the way that you're comfortable with, because you have confidence when you're in this position. That is when you're gonna be at your very best. Good luck.
Secret closer to elimination. M80 victorious, taking them down in a two mapper. That series was short, like Jesse.
Yeah. Well.
Hold on. When we walked into this studio, you said that, and I was like, I'm gonna say
it.
You
have to do it to me like that.
You said it when we were walking into the studio.
It took away my box. Actually, like for real talk, I had a box last segment. I don't know what happens.
Aw, so cute.
Okay, sorry.
Isn't there a game that just happened or something?
No.
We should talk about instead.
No.
Yeah. You want to talk about that? Oh, okay. I thought we were talking about your height and you not getting your box. Where is his box, by the way? Come on now. They're just doing you dirty today. Okay. So, yes, let's talk about this matchup a little bit more. And M80 defeated Secret Map 1 on Secret's map pick border.
Mm-hmm.
Ouch. Jacob, that was a dominant performance there. And you were hyping Diaz in the pre-show and he turned up.
He turned up overall in the series, even if this map in particular doesn't necessarily show it. He wasn't somebody who had to nearly as much because, again, the role that Diaz plays doesn't require him to be first in spite of him having, you know, one entry kill. Again, that's not necessarily his job. I actually had more concerns about guys like Yaga after the way that they played from yesterday. So Yaga in this map especially was a guy to step up. And Kino was the highest rated player overall and led in several statistical categories in this lobby. So Diaz is a guy who, if you see him at the very top of a leaderboard for an event, that's actually kind of problematic for some teams based on the way that they decide to compose themselves.
And Jesse, you talked about Slebin in the pre-show.
Yeah.
You're a little hard on him. You're like, I want to see more from you.
Sure.
He didn't quite deliver on map one, unfortunately.
I mean, his stats weren't bad. Like, you look at the numbers, and it's not the end of the world. However, it just felt like round after round after round, he was in these low man count situations where he really needed to step up for his team, and he just never seemed to be able to drive that point home. First, it was round four. They're in the 3v3, and they give M80 so much space to get the plant down. They really don't get aggressive enough in that moment to stop it. The very next round, Slevin's in a 2v2 playing Tachanka, and the gun does him no favors, loses the gunfight to the hatch up above. Two rounds later, he's in another 2v2 alongside Kendru, which that one was close. I thought they did decently, but the coordination just not there. And then two rounds after that, he's in another one. It's a 1v1 for here, and he's planting under the Valcam, where he could have been trying to trade his partner with the Nook and maybe trying to stop it from getting to a 1v1 to begin with. It just felt like every time he was in the high pressure, low man count situations, he was fumbling the bag a little bit. And so it got better map two, I would say. I think he had a much better map two than map one. But when it really mattered, he was struggling there, Jackie.
Okay, so you were talking about transitioning to map two. Kind of a stomping, to be completely honest. M80, you know, they were strong here for sure. Jacob, you've been consistently singing their praises. And when we were in the green room, you were like, they're perfect. They did very well here.
Well, no, hold on. I didn't say M80
were
perfect.
Say that.
I didn't know. I didn't say M80
were
perfect.
Oh, no, you were here. You heard him say that.
I didn't even say their defenses were perfect. I said they won every defense. And to be clear, there definitely were some mistakes because there were some holes in their defenses that Secret were trying to exploit because there were times that Secret would just sneak in and try to get a plant down. In some cases, they did, but that came with them not doing a whole bunch of the other necessary steps you need for Clubhouse. You can't just sneak onto a bomb site, get a diffuser down, and expect to get that player out alive, even less so when you're trying to make sure you actually win the round and have a successful post plant. If someone's in a turtle position, maybe downstairs, you've got more of an opportunity to do that. And they tried to get somebody in there, but there were still too many players from M80 that were left alive. I can't even get my words out because these guys were trying and they just left out some steps from the formula, and you can't do that on club. You just can't.
Yeah, I mean, I think their defenses were at least pretty close to perfect. They got a little scrappy towards the end. I mean, the bar stage round was a little bit, you know, come down to the 1v1, say what you will, but they got it done, right? End of the day, they were always really good about denying that plant. They were always really good about making sure Secret couldn't get those kits down. So yeah, I thought it was a very solid second half from M80.
Okay, and we're going to bring up MVP in a hot second here, but Jesse, I know you want to talk about Gomez really quickly, so
yeah, I mean, I just, a small point, I think Gomez started really, really strong on attack before we got to that defensive half. I thought he was getting entry pick after entry pick, and then we kind of had that attack timeout get called for Secret. Felt like they started to change up their play style a little bit. Secret got a little bit more kind of unpredictable, and it felt like Gomez started to struggle a little bit more on those entries, but I just wanted to say I thought it was a great start from Gomez.
Okay, well, he wasn't our MVP.
Well,
no.
Just saying. But I'm sure y'all can guess who it was.
Kiki.
Kino. Yeah,
yeah. It should put him be. Up. Yeah, there he is. Look, man, it's not very often that we get to give the MVP honor to a support player, but we do it usually because he has a crazy stats lead against most of the other people on his team, and Kino absolutely did that. 133, a plus 9 KD difference, which, again, for a support player, is already insane. He was 0-5 on entry, but we honestly should put up the fact that he had 2 clutches and 3 plants, yeah. And that is more than any of every other team or player on this in the lobby combined. Kino was doing fantastic in this matchup. And it's like him alongside DS, alongside Yaga, along the fact that Gomez was turning up when he needed to turn up, all of that made it possible for Kino to lift this today.
I think his border was really good. His border was really, really strong. He had that good Ying play on the top floor, and then on defense, I thought he did a great job kind of working in that late round, oftentimes against Slevin, going back to that point. So it felt like he was really holding it down there on border. And then second map as well, not a bad performance at all. I think he definitely deserves MVP.
Okay, let's look ahead to the future. FaZe wins one map, Secret is out. I mean, that's tough when you're a team and your fate is in the hands of another team, to be completely honest.
Look, again, we're in a scenario where there isn't a team so far at this Invitational that has lost 3 of their matchups and has survived so far, because both Dire Wolves and Elevate are already gone, and that was the same case for both of them. The only difference here is that Secret has already won a map in one of their matchups. They did that, and now we're still wanting them to continue forward, but it requires a lot more help and them winning their game tomorrow, which, again, that's a whole other battle because there's still so many things they have to do it.
So Secret are on 1 point right now. They can get a max 5 points total in the group. FaZe Clan are currently on 5. Everybody else is above that. But FaZe Clan are playing right now. If FaZe Clan win a single map, then they'll be at least at 6, and then Secret are out. So Secret could be out by the time we finish this panel.
Unfortunately, by the time we're back and we have to do the game after this, they could already be gone.
Yeah.
Jesse and I making sad faces. It's SI. People are going to get eliminated, unfortunately. I do want to talk about the future for M80. It's pretty bright, in my opinion.
Look, I'm gonna level with you. Even though we don't have a Dark Zero game to do, I've not been impressed by Dark Zero's play so far. I think the fact that they got that win to start off with against Heroic still came with a loss in map 1, and there were a lot of discombobulating things happening. They've won 2 series, but remember how that series against Secret finished up last night? 20 seconds left. They have to rush onto Throne Room on Theme Park. They don't have any walls open. They just have to go in, get kills, and hope that it's going to work. And luckily for them, it did. Honestly, they should have lost that. M80 look like they're primed to win this group after all. If FaZe Clan are able to clear through Heroic and then maybe beat Secret tomorrow, then they might have a shot. I don't really see a path or a way in which M80 doesn't get 1, if not 2nd in this group still.
Yeah, M80 looks like they're probably going to win the group.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what was that?
They're probably going to win the group.
I'm sorry.
They might not. I mean, Dark Zero could win.
Jesse, say it one more time.
They're probably going to win the group.
Thank you. I've been taking the whole week.
You are a piece of work.
All week I've wanted you to say this.
We'll see.
Okay. All of you at home, I'll take care of them. Don't you worry. But go check out Stream B because we do have that FaZe versus Heroic series going on right now. Oof. Yeah, I'm not going to say anything. Just go check it out.